Hey, what up? What up? What up? What up? What up? Can you guys hear me?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. There we go. That's one down. There we go. Audio issues abound, and we got one in. And we are late. And that happens. So, late boys. I was playing Sam's old song called Chopper, and I love that tune. And he was like, "Hey, sneak in this new song I have going on." So we tried to get that going on, and I fucked something up. So there was like a weird gap of no music, and that was me.
No, I fucked something up.
Sorry guys. Anyway, welcome to Trailer Boys. My name is Nate Brown. I am the caretaker manager of Trailer Boys. Sitting to my left, is that my left? No, it's my right, is Sam Brown.
Yeah, you're right.
The Trailer Boy himself, Sam Brown. This is my right.
Hello.
Hello. If you are coming to us, you've probably seen the show before, but I assume there's a bunch of people that haven't seen the show. So we're going to say what we do is we watch trailers and we talk some shit and, you know, we vote on the trailers. Sam, do you remember where we get these trailers from?
We get them from you.
Me?
No, the fans.
You, the viewers.
All the viewers and fans of Trailer Boys.
And the trailers come in from there. Submit trailers to... My hand gets disappeared, but misery loves us. Yeah. I can't hear a fucking word you're saying. I can't get over your vest. Can you please take it off? No, it's fucking cold as shit. This was my Marty McFly Halloween costume. Sam, your audio is wonky. Yeah, it has that like bubbly sound I think we've dealt with before. I know it's been me before on yours, so I'm not sure. Oh, yeah, we do points. Let me look up the points real quick. So we submit points. We're in season two right now, guys. And we have a lot of new people in. I feel bad. I think I did not... Is my mic fucked up? I think I missed a bunch of donos.
Is this better?
I don't know. Talk a little bit. Explain how the points work, Sam.
I'm talking a little bit. So the points work in a way that's fun. It's totally fun, totally cool. What happens is we watch a trailer. I decide if I want to give that trailer 0, 1, or 2 points. Nate decides if he wants to give that trailer 0, 1, or 2 points. And then the audience votes on it. If 75% to 100% of the audience vote yes, then that point gets 3 points from you. That trailer gets 3 points from you. If 50 to 74 vote yes, that gets 2 points from you. 25 to 49, 1 point. And you might get confusing because you might see 53% say no, which means that, 47% said yes, which means 1 point. And then, 0 to 25 or 24, that's zero. I'm still messed up. Here, wait, let me...
Am I out of sync too? I don't know how to fix the out of sync thing. But your audio engine is prioritizing latency over quality. I do love chat. I appreciate chat. No, somebody in chat said it. Bitcom said it. I do love that. Like, we have so many people to help us out in chat. Sam and I have been working on a Secret Santa project, actually, and we've been getting a lot of help from people in chat. Do you know what, Sam? Do you remember the Secret Santa project?
Yes.
Actually, if you nightbot Secret Santa command, you'll see the details. Pretty much, we have a friend that also streams on this channel, and he does, without giving too much information away, he does a cooking show. And, you know, it takes a lot of technology. You know, we need a lot of help in there. Obviously now we need help too, and there's two of us here, and we have like computers from the future. So what we're trying to do is help our friend out and upgrade some of his stuff. So I was streaming this week, and I did some game streams, and Beansy and Thicken Wing were so kind to donate some money. So we're gonna try and buy some gear. So if anyone else wants to donate, check the Secret Santa link. And interesting enough, some of the gear I was looking at on eBay is coming up soon. So it's clearly Darren. I wish if Darren was like, hey, I need help and I would like to stream, I told him I'm there for him. So and you guys too, I know, can help out. I don't think any of this would have been possible without the guys in chat. So you guys know who you are. I appreciate. Yeah, obviously the movie, if you want to donate to the movie, donate in this channel here.
How's this?
I think you sound great all the time, but I'm a big fan of yours, so.
I mean, does it sound okay to you through Discord?
It comes and goes. I mean, it sounds warbly to me as well. Is it my Discord maybe that's fucked up, you think?
No, you're clicking. Like, this kind of clicking?
No, it's definitely like a bubbly, crackly in your voice. And I think you've told me I've sounded like that before. So I wonder if it is like a Discord thing.
Yeah, Discord's crazy sometimes.
Discord's crazy, man. It's not awful. Like, it's fine. Whoa. Marth subscribed for 15 months. Yeah. What's going on? Also, I want to give a shout out to Micromegas is a Prime subscriber for 14 months. So we get some long dongs in here. Is that how to say it? Is that the word? Long dongs?
Dongs? Yeah.
Long dongs? Guys that
are like a wiener? Long. Yeah.
Yeah. Lochelius has resubscribed for 7 months. So you guys get some good shit going on. Try restarting voice meter, Sam.
I have.
I'm not saying this. Steve will said this.
I've said it. I restarted it.
Corin J says, we need more channel points awards. Give me more. Like what? What can you do with channel points? Is that a whole separate thing? I think you sound great.
Is this getting better?
Yeah, that sounds good. I think you might have it.
Okay.
Tell me about what you did this week. Did you stream? What were your streams like? Yeah, your streams. I want to hear how your voice sounds.
Oh, I did a stream where I actually figured out how to get the audio from my Ableton ASIO into VoiceMeter using a virtual cable, and did a whole stream where I made a beat, which I think some people thought that the song The Chopper was that song, but that's not Chopper.
Oh, you didn't do Chopper live?
No, I did not do Chopper live.
Did you play any games? Did you play the new Warrior Zone?
All right, wait, I'm going to restart my computer because I've been playing. You hang on because you're doing the stream. I have the freedom to do this. It'll take me 2 seconds. I'll be right back.
Okay, time to get serious, chat. I don't know about Warzone. Yeah, 2 hours later. I went through some of the VODs and was looking at, like, we generally start the show, like, actually start the show, like an hour into it. So we got time, right? We're just bullshitting anyway. Is Sam frozen or did he log off, you think? I can't tell if he's not moving or if he actually restarted his computer. Sam? Is he frozen? It looks like I'm going to put my arm around him. I have an alarm here. So again, I all jokes aside, Timmy got a bunch of new computer gear, and we're definitely, you know, and somebody donated a really solid video card to him. A bunch of people donated. So we're trying to buy him some stuff. And it's like, you know, computer gear is expensive. There's shortages. So the used market is also getting expensive. So we got enough stuff. I'm trying to match donations. What kind of gear? You know, everything. We started with a graphics card. He had like a computer. And then when we took it apart, we were like walking him through putting it together. It was rough. And I was like, holy shit, this is tough. And it was a mini ITX case, so it was like really, really tight spaces. And he's not used to it. So I think it was kind of hard. And I'm watching this Aorus Gaming 5 motherboard from Gigabyte. And it comes with, I think, an 8800 processor and 32 gigs of RAM. And the guy put it up for $50. And he's like, I don't know what I have. And he said it worked. But I'd still like to see. Combat gear, game gear. Yeah, game gear, computer gear. Maybe. It's a solid maybe. Oh, whoa. We switched. Now I'm here. Does it have vacuum? I don't know what that means. Yeah, just before Christmas. The same back on already? Watching Airheads right now. I love that movie. In space, no one can hear you cream. Subscribed at tier. Thank you very much for the subscription. Thank you on behalf of Sam, because I'm the only one here.
Hey.
If we could raise those Asimer earmics, are expensive, but if we could get one for Timmy, we'd get one for Timmy. there are a few episodes of Self Suck that have not gone up. That I would like to put up soon. There's one episode that I consider my favorite episode of Self Suck of all time, and it was a nightmare. It was crazy, and it was, I don't think it was Trevor's last Self Suck, but it was Trevor's in it, and we'll drop that on Christmas Day as a present for everyone.
Trevor's last Self Suck, I think, was my favorite.
Was that the one that was just like a dumpster fire and you restarted a bunch of times?
The Chris Chan one, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So that's my favorite episode of Self Suck of all time. It is so fucked up, and I have to figure out, like, A, I don't think it's a monetizable video at all, because you guys get into it really fucking early. And a lot of times they say like the first 10 minutes has to be really... did you turn your camera on yet? Because people were saying the mic sounds good.
Okay. Cool. I've probably just been running my computer for too long.
And if it doesn't sound good, everyone shut the fuck up. Let's just do the show. It sounds good enough.
That's fine. I want it to sound good for people.
Let me put the camera on. Any sexy Chris Chan stories? Beach that makes you old. Comment to well, the night so far.
There's one that comes to mind. Are you like all these other people on who's into like that stuff where on Pornhub where the people are fucking the stepmom? Well, I got a sexy story for you about Chris Chan.
I wonder if Chris Chan is like, it's fine. It's very popular right now. Everyone's doing this in pornography. It's a very common thing. And they're like, no, it's not. Whoa, Principal Rolls gifting tier one subs. Thank you, sir. Like, or madam.
It's
wait. Okay, we're winning this bid right now so far, guys.
Timmy knows. It's no secret. Timmy, I told him.
Oh,
it's not
a secret. Oh, okay.
No.
Why did you tell him?
I told you this.
Okay.
Because he called me and asked me about this, about the power supply, so I had to explain to him what the whole thing was.
Oh, I think you lost a light somewhere too.
No, the camera settings just got screwed with.
My camera settings reset a lot. They reset, and I'm losing my shoulder a bunch. All right, guys, we have 5 minutes left, and I'm afraid it might get sniped. You want to send a shirt to Zach, say, I stand Chris Chan, stand with Chris Chan? That's pretty good. What's funny is I was telling Sam the analytics of YouTube, and I'm not super familiar with it, but like you go in and you can see the timeline, and then there are like these bumps. And I was like, it's really weird because this one marker had like a ton of views, and it's like way at the end of the thing. And I'm like, you can click on it and watch it. And you click on it, watch it, and it's just Zach being like, maybe she was horny. You know, who knows? Maybe she was horny. And I was like, oh, of course. And then I'm like, why did everyone just zero in on that? And then sure enough, somebody in chat or somebody in the comments linked it specifically. Okay. Somebody's trying to outbid us on this, guys. Hendo has also subscribed 15 months. Wow.
What is someone watching? What is someone watching right now?
Who?
Are is watching to the VOD? Are sniping.
Oh, really? You think they'll be sniping for Timmy?
Stream snipe bidding. Is that a thing?
This is the first time I've actually used eBay without like a sniping app in years, because it's like everyone does it, so it makes it not worth, you know, normal bidding or watching like we're doing now, which is not interesting to you guys, but I think this would be a big help for him.
Yeah, we're going to get him set up, and like the whole thing is he's going to be doing two computer streams where he'll be streaming from his PC, the tower and everything, and then he'll have his laptop in the kitchen with him, kind of calling into that one.
Yeah, so we're trying to set up to make it easy for him with different angles and just make the show easier, and then, you know, album out streaming wise. So again, to separate the money donated for the movie, which should be donated on this channel, if you donate the money on my link, which is under the Secret Santa tag, all that money I'm getting, because no one tips me anyway, so I'm going, putting all that towards Timmy stuff, and I'm matching donation. I'm not matching donations, because that would be a little heavy. Who knows how heavy it could be, but I'm filling out the rest of it. And then Sam and the guys,
Another thing, so me and the guys got him a power supply and a case, an NZXT, what's that, like H51 case, or like they're like,
yeah, it's their standard
NZXT case, which is a good case.
But you got it on sale too. All right, and Thick and Wing also is resubscribed for 15 months. We have a lot of 15 month people in tonight. Wow. And a couple 14 months. That's some good stuff. NZXT is the functioning definition of no airflow. True, that's why we need donations for a nice air cooler, or a cooler. It doesn't have to be an air cooler, but... And we just punch some speed holes in it.
Yeah. We'll be out there with pickaxe, punching speed holes in.
Focus. How are you, Sam? We didn't get the game out
at all this week. Not really focusing.
I played some Destiny 2 this week. I don't know if anyone in chat played some Destiny 2 this week, but it's kind of cool.
Battlefield is that lonely. Did they just...
They put out some new stuff.
They just put
Professor
out some
Mark,
new stuff.
Professor Mark, did your tip go through? Because stream elements page is kind of weird. I don't know. Let me check. I'm sorry. That should be stupid, because I should be watching the tip pages on my... Of course, this is how I do it. All right, stream elements. I forgot to log in on my thing. Oh, boom! We got some tips in.
Oh, we got tips.
Yeah, Professor Marth threw out 50 bones, man. And 50 bones. Joanna Claudette threw in too. 69. Nice.
Oh, is that?
We're getting some dope shit.
Is that for Timmy or for?
For Timmy. This is on my tip page. And I want to give a shout out for T Bunk also, the other day, threw down. Forgot. So Thick and Wing, Beans, and T Bunk from the other day for the Timmy Fund. All right, 53 seconds. Let's see
if we get sniped. You know what? You know what I got? What we should do is we should make his system on PC Parts Picker.
I've already done that, brother.
And see if people have suggestions.
Yeah. Well, if we win this auction here, we're getting like a bunch of cool shit. It's 32 gigs of RAM, a nice gigabyte Aorus motherboard.
Well, you just cut out from me.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought we were just freezing.
No, you cut out from me. What processor is it?
Oh, we got outbid with 1 second left. Oh, wow. That's a snipe bid. Wow, I got outbid by $5, y'all. What bullshit is this? All right, so this is why we need help. This is why we need financial help. So, unfortunately, we got outbid. It was 32 gigs of RAM, an Intel i5-8800. You know, it's not the newest shit, but it's only 3 years old. It would have been great for him. So, damn, guys. We're going to have to raise more money. We're going to keep at it. Computer voice. Sleevik Dickle. This is, I think, so Timmy, I think he would get too anxious if he was building it on stream, but I think that if he did it and we...
Nate. He, I talked to him. He said he would be down to build it on stream. We can do computer boys.
Yes! we've had two computer boys in the past, and they're both very, very boring because it was like one of us doing it and then the other person just kind of dicking around. So now maybe it'll be less boring because it'll be Sam and I hosting and then Timmy will be doing his thing. So anyway, sorry guys.
Oh yeah, he said, you know what's funny is he said, oh fuck, if I do this I'm gonna have to figure out how to get my laptop working, but actually no, he doesn't, because one of us can stream.
That's what I'm saying.
He has to call in.
Anyway, so that's what we're updated to. I appreciate everyone helping out. Rest of Pizza has resubscribed with Prime Gaming for 12 months. Nice.
Do you know what I learned today?
What's that?
Because of this? Because I'm an AMD boy, not one of these Intel punks. I finally learned how to read an Intel, the numbering system for the processors. And boy, ooh, it's confusing. But I mean,
yeah.
It's not that confusing.
I'm missing muscular dawn. True.
I finally found out that, like, all right, what an i5, i7, i9, those are different like types of their processors. But then that first number, the fourth digit, or you know, like. If it's a 7-7, if it's a 7700, that means it's seventh generation 700 chip. Pretty cool, huh?
That makes sense.
I didn't know that. Do you know that?
I assumed.
But like, you know, like,
because it's the 11th generation chip and it's like the 1100, you know, like, you know, it's all the same.
But then did you know about the eyes? I didn't know about the eyes. Clutch Skateboards just rated. Thanks, Clutch.
I like skateboards. I used to skateboard.
Yeah, I used to skateboard too.
You want to do the show?
Yeah, let's do the show we've been doing for 34 minutes, but haven't actually done anything of.
You know what? The good thing, though, is we did get through the explanation of the show real quick.
Yeah. This may be the slowest start yet, though.
Keep vamping. The scene is called Vamp, by the way. That's a funny part of this. Do you want to watch last week's? Look at all the skate falls in recognition of Clutch Skateboards.
Oh, it's Clutch Skateboards. What's Clutch Skateboards? What do you guys do in your stream?
You should follow them.
My
My move transition worked. Did anyone notice? I was trying to get this to work before. Oh, fuck.
Clutch skateboards there. Make fuck. Skateboards. I'm definitely following Clutch skateboards.
That's cool. I'm into Clutch.
Wait.
I used to hang out at the house in Queens a lot.
Oh. Wait, Clutch skateboards. Who are you?
Who are you? The white Volvo 240 was my first car. I love a mystery.
Ooh. Ned gave you that Volvo, huh?
I would hate if people played games like this with me because I have such a bad memory. I'd be like, Jeff, Mike. Classic Ned.
I mean, I remember Ned. Is this, wait, were you roommates with Bill in the Chinatown place or no? Oh, you're Ned's friend. All right, well. Who was that roommate of his? The one that was Keith Richards' assistant.
Ham Goblin has resubscribed. I remember Ham Goblin. Ham Goblin was like the first call,
Dave,
right?
Yeah, that was Dave. Ham Goblin. Oh, yeah, I remember Ham Goblin.
Was the Queen's apartment the one where you had the mini ramp in the backyard?
Yep.
And then you broke your foot? Arm?
I didn't break my arm. I, like, sprained it. And then there was a party where I was doing kick turns and I threw the sling off and everyone was like, oh my god! That's so rad that you threw your sling off!
Was that Generation Viper shit?
No, it was way after.
Alright.
Should we watch this?
Yeah. I don't know if anyone was here last week, but I went when I was editing the VOD, which should be up this week. I didn't realize that this came in like right at the end. Time. This one was the last pick of mine. I picked this in, and you know I get half credit here for selecting this one, right? Don't we have a smaller game going where, like, the winners we get points for? Is that just a brother thing? Is that just between you and me? Or is it just me?
I think it's just me?
All right, it's me and Chet.
No, it's not really a competition.
I mean, okay. But this one came in late. This was, like, the last one. And it blew my fucking mind. And I didn't realize it was like a thing. It's been out there. Patton Oswalt does a bit on it. Beansy sent me a clip to that. It was pretty good. But here we go. Settle in for Christmas shoes. Pay attention to the lyrics of the song.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. Sometimes the smallest of miracles. We wish you a Merry Christmas. Sometimes the smallest of miracles. Can change our lives. And for one man.
Daddy! Didn't think you were coming.
And a boy.
I used to have this pair of dancing shoes. Every time I put them on, I just felt so special.
A special pair of shoes will lead their paths to cross.
You would have really liked the show. I wished you were there.
Come with me next time.
Why wasn't he there?
$5.50 short. Come back after New Year's, we'll probably be giving them away.
Too late.
This Christmas, two families will test their faith in themselves.
Thanks, mister.
And discover the magic.
What a
that
dick.
Is the Christmas.
The guy working there?
You're $5 short. Fuck you.
Dude, he's working at a store during Christmas. He's got and there was a line, and he's got to deal with this kid with like change. It's like, give me a credit card. You give me change. I count all the change. We got $5. I'm on that guy's side. Look, he's crying again. He's banging on the window. Like, that's probably the store.
Golden Globe nominee Rob Lowe.
Jeez, how much I love you. and Kimberly Williams Paisley of According to Jim.
And only According to Jim.
He didn't know he needed a miracle until one happened.
So what are you going to do with all that real whole lot of money?
Buy my mom some Christmas shoes.
Inspired by the hit
song. If you said that to a kid, book, right?
The Christmas Shoes.
The song that became a book.
Whole lot of money?
Only yeah. From GT Media.
So if you said, hey, kid, what are you going to do with all that money? And he was like, buy my mom some Christmas shoes. Wouldn't you be like, wait, that's just kind of like an odd gift. But what, Christmas shoes? Why don't you say, buy my mom a Christmas gift? Like, he doesn't have to get that detailed on it, but he's like so proud of it. Christmas shoes. Yeah. It's like, come on. That kid's weird. That kid's going to grow up to be a weird adult.
Yeah, that kid's definitely weird.
You guys know that, right.
The actor's weird.
I want to see that movie. Christmas, yeah. Tasia says, they're just called shoes, you little shit. Yeah. Shoes. Christmas shoes.
Christmas shoes.
Well, Rongina with the dig.
He's going to go, when's she going to wear them next year? Yeah, right. She's dying of cancer.
No, they're not New Year's Eve shoes. She doesn't have that long. Oh, that's bad. It's bad. Frank Howley is ready with a party of 51.
51? Oh, it's the raid song. Time to raid song. I'm talking about the raid song for the 51 people coming in here on watching our show about trailers.
And Cuties Max Racer cheered 200 bits. I think that's like $6,000.
What?
Frank Howley, if you guys haven't been following him, do give him a follow. His show has been great. He's been watching this, I think it's Arizona Public Access show from the 90s. And it's like a little kid. He's smart. He's smarter than he looks. He looks younger, but and they're just like playing like Mortal Kombat and video games and stuff and talking shit. And they start taking callers. And it's Sam. You remember when we were kids, there was like Rust News, and then like
Rust News. Like, yeah.
What was the fantasy one called? It was like Space Fantasy. It was just. It was a nightmare. It was crazy. But this is kind of like that. And so. I forget. We had another fantasy one. And then you had your own show.
Yeah, TV Galactica.
But
we never really aired episodes. We never
really shot stuff.
We shot stuff. We shot a shit ton of stuff and then never aired it.
Have you ever seen the Milwaukee Christian Public Access puppet show Rob Schrab and Dan Harmon run? No. That sounds amazing.
I'm going to ask him about that. Wait. Should we do my segment?
Yeah, I just want to. All right, yeah, you just say you do your. Let's do this, and then you know what? I'll give the top five leaderboard.
You ready?
Ba, 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 ba. No, it's still playing the coming attractions. I'm moving to go. Oh, wait. I kept playing.
Oh, you need to fix that.
Yeah, although I do love this song.
Yeah, but I mean, you can just not have the.
Yeah, I'll figure it out. All right, we're ready to see it. Is that Alicia Silverstone?
Amazing.
Yeah.
So far.
She looks great.
We are here for this. Nothing. Which is exactly what we're going to do the whole time we're here.
Wait a minute. A room above the water is
existential?
I hope, I guess.
Fell off the bed! There's a lot of blood.
We could be anywhere. What are we gonna do?
We need to focus on surviving. How long can we last in all this?
They'll come for us.
Why would you light your boat on fire?
What was that?
Because then people would see the fire.
I just saw something. It's a shark! We're not gonna die. We're gonna be okay.
The Requin? The Requin?
The Requin. What the fuck is that? A Requin?
Let me just say, like, I was like, I did not give a shit. You know what? Because it's like, oh, they have that kind of vacation money, you know?
Yeah.
They have that money where they can do that kind of vacation? Sure. They can, you know what? They lived a good life. You know,
I will tell you this. When I see this Sabin production card, I get pumped up. They make the hottest trash out there. Right? Like, am I wrong in this? It's
Enigmatic Booty Bandit says, I reckon I won't be watching that.
Well, that's why we watch trailers. Why we watch trailers.
Did it.
All right, here we go.
Is Sabin the same guys that did Power Rangers or no?
Yeah. Hey, think okay. So. Oh wait, shit.
Are we going in again? I'm like, let's do it. Let's pick it apart.
James Baker.
Some more Sabin.
Military.
Is that the Lawnmower Man?
Yeah, I tell you, I'm very.
Yeah.
Is that Michael J. White?
It's nice to have you home.
I feel much better now.
Yeah.
I found something in my room.
You found all of that money?
We have to tell Mom and Dad.
You don't know who this money belongs to.
I heard you were getting out today.
Oh, Jesus.
Let's go.
I'm already in. I'm in.
Where is it? Our old house.
Dad, there's some guys in the house. Dad, you need to go home.
I remember that scene.
from Taken?
What are we gonna do?
Don't worry, I'm built for this. Enough with the kids, sweetheart. You gotta go.
Fuck, I'm in.
I'm in.
I'm not like that much of a Mickey Rourke guy, but it adds that like sauce. So it's like, I like Michael J. White, and I feel that he hasn't gotten enough like good shit. You know, he's in a bunch of hot garbage, and he's like, I like him. He's good. And I'll point out that I knew it was him very early on. Does that make me not racist? Do I get points for that?
No.
All right. Yeah, because I recognized him.
They're asking. Because
you know when people like confuse somebody for somebody else,
you recognize one black man, you're not racist.
A little bit less. It takes
more than that.
Okay. Well, I'm trying. But Michael J. White, I love, and then the guy from Lawnmower Man, who I don't even know his name, but he's got the eyes. I like him, and then Mickey Rourke just adds like that little like it's this. It's good. Everything.
I think it's. Jeff Fahey is from Lawnmower Man. In the movie Body Parts.
I haven't seen Body Parts.
It was cool. Good period movies. Are you ready for one more?
I am.
This is also my favorite period of film. I love January and February, where like the trashiest shit comes out.
Period of film. I thought you were talking about like the 80s. You're talking about like the
no, no, no. of the year. Yeah, like when they're just like when studios are just dumping their garbage and going, I hope no one makes fun of us. It's the fucking best. There's a ton of fun stuff that comes out. That is, it's all like bad, but it's all like, well, it's not like that bad.
Is there a reasoning why they put it out at this time?
I think it's because there's less people going to, it's like they already put out, they put out all the Oscar films right at the end of the year. Like everyone's trying to get all their Oscar stuff out. And so there's like this influx of content in December and like this like prestige content. And then, and like, you know, a lot of people go to movies like after Christmas and on Christmas break and stuff like that. And then out in the new year, I just think it's like less people going to movies. It's less emphasis on movies. There's so much stuff for people to get through that they just like get everything out before we get into the blockbuster summer that starts in like March.
That makes sense.
So, yeah. So January and February, you get the best hot garbage.
Ari sends some gifted 5 tier 1 subs. T-Bunker gifted a tier 1 sub. Thank you, guys.
About George Washington's first female spy during the Revolution. They called her Agent 355 because they didn't want the world to know her real name. But her legacy lives on.
Stop hitting yourself!
Around the world. American.
They called her Agent 355 because they didn't want the world to know her real name. And also, they thought there was 354 agents that they wanted to protect more.
World War III. From simple reach of their keyboard.
So we need to join forces.
It's like half the CIA's most wanted.
Always such a tough guy.
I'm not an agent, I'm a therapist.
They thought I would give you my secrets.
Do you have secrets?
We put ourselves in danger so that others are not.
I'll handle the guns.
Are you in therapy?
I should be.
You're the best in the world at what you do.
You have cameras in your jewelry, comms in your earrings.
You bump, I grab.
The target is on the move.
You're not going in there alone.
We'll go together. I have a family. I cannot do this anymore.
The bad guys are out there right now. You go home. You bring them with you. Are you under control?
Are you?
No. Black cars,
all black, everything. I've got 4 more agents out on the street.
I counted 6, but thanks for the tip.
The new team.
We're the 355. We gon' run this town.
See, January 7th.
It's like, it was like tedious to watch the trailer.
Oh, I am pumped.
Like, I'm definitely gonna watch it. But yeah. Like, man.
All right.
I don't.
It's got a lot going for it, though. Sebastian Stan, Jessica Chastain, fucking just some, like, knockoff Bourne Identity shit.
Well, it's the Bourne people, right? No?
Yeah, yeah. Like...
Man, I'm all for... Like, I get, I don't know what I'm trying to say, but it's like a women-fronted action movie, and I'm like, yeah, I'm into that. I'm for it. I support it. But it's like, it doesn't make it, like, better, right, than, I don't know. It just, the 355 thing really ruined it. Like, the whole, like, at the start of it, like, the title of it, and this is why, and I was just like, you know?
Yeah, I mean, there is, like, it sounds like there is no plot to it, because like even like Bourne Identity was like, let's you know, there's a secret agent who like there's a secret agent who loses his memory and he's starting to and it's like, oh, that's great, that's fucking cool,
and he's using like books to like beat people up and shit.
It gets to that, but yeah. This is just like, what if there were secret agents and what if they were four women? Or five women?
Yeah.
It's like,
my thing is, like, if you played me that same trailer, right, and it was five dudes, right, and it was like, we're like the dude, whatever, would it be a better movie?
The question is, would I see it? Yes, I would see it.
I mean, you'd see this, I'd see this, but I'm saying, like, if it was dudes, I don't think it would be even sillier, you know? Like, if it was dudes. Like, I'd be like, it's doesn't make it, I don't know.
So what's your point? Your point is that it's better with women, or you said it would be sillier with dudes?
I feel like if you put dudes, can we watch it again? And just everyone picture it like a dude, you know, like we're fellas, you know, like that kind of thing. We're dudes putting it together because we're a dude team, you know. It would be sillier. Oh man, we got gifted subs going all over the place. Thank you, everyone. So I'll let Sam read it.
But yeah, also, it would have to be like a.
The trailer was fucking long as shit. But let me just watch the beginning of it. Ready?
Remember that story that they told us about in training?
About George Washington's first female spy during the Revolution. They called her Agent 355 because they didn't want the world to know her real name.
Spies. Nobody knows spies' real name anyway. All the spies have agent names. Just because she's a woman, they're like, nobody running any spies wants people to know the spy's name, right?
I think, you know, like, afterwards, a lot of time people can be like, I mean, I guess I don't know any spy's name.
But her legacy lives on.
James Bond told everyone his name straight up.
Yeah, James Bond told everyone his name.
That was funny. Like, boom, in the face.
American, but I think you're British, missing the point, though.
German, Colombian.
Wait, what's the point?
I think she's saying that it was Agent 355 because they didn't want her to have any notoriety.
Okay.
Agent 355 is a cool story. Is that a real story?
Yeah, I'm with you. If they had a story about that actual, like, Agent 355, I'd be into that. Like, make a fucking story up too. But Jessica Chastain was in like some Netflix movie that took place in Boston that was really bad, and that was kind of like she was an assassin. And so like this looks kind of like the same thing. And I was like, oof. They didn't want history to know that George fucking Washington needed a girl. Yeah. It's pretty much like the Bad News Bears trailer that we watched, you know? That's what George Washington... Which it was edited. Yeah. The Bad News Bears, the sports episode of Trailer Boys is on the VOD, but it has been heavily edited to remove sketchiness. Yeah, and I had to edit the holiday trailer because when I stood up, my whole ass was hanging out of my pants. My whole ass.
Oh, yeah, this is a real thing.
Hey, we learned something. Again, if the movie does anything, we've at least learned an actual historical fact. I don't know if this movie helps that or, like, plays into it or does it any homage, but it's like... I don't know. It just... Here's my hope. I hope it's as fun and entertaining as, like, Fast and the Furious. Because, like, when you watch a trailer for Fast and the Furious, which, if we were rabbit-holing right now, I don't think we should rabbit-hole in the coming attractions, but, we should watch the original Fast and the Furious trailer sometime. Because, like, you gotta put yourself in, like, how... Or, like, XXX, one of my favorite fucking movies of all time, is just silly. Silly! But I love that movie. Have you looked at the list, Sam?
No.
Whoever wants it.
I was reading that 355. And I think the thing is that Is that like, you know, you from the Revolutionary War, there are spies that people that are, you know, famed spies, but Agent 355 is just Agent 355 in the history books.
Oh, so we actually don't know her name.
Yeah.
All right. Let me go into this. Let me say this. Sam, you look for a trailer. The theme should be in the thing. It's movies where the world blows up, it's based on an old coworker of Sam's, and that was his favorite type of movie, movies where the world blows up. So we thought it was kind of funny. So yeah. It's, you know, apocalyptic movies. Maybe we'll rabbit hole some Roland Emmerich. We did watch Moonfall trailer last week. Moonfall?
Yeah.
But there's a bunch of ones. I haven't even looked at it. I'll say this, though. Season 2, we're not very far into season 2, but the top 5... in the leaderboard right now, it's Flanja on the top. Flanja, we know from in the top 10 of last season. Beach That Makes You Old in second place. Schwingles, also from season 1, in third place. Scott 91575 in fourth place. Avalanche Fan in fifth place. So that's 3 of the top 5 are known people from last year. Professor Marth Live. Haven't seen you in the show in season 2, so don't got much for you right now. Niamix is in the top 10.
All right.
I won't say where. I just want to do it with the 5. All right, Sam, you got something?
I got a trailer. Yep. Here we go. Ready?
Beep, boop, boop, beep.
Temperatures have soared. In 2013, when the Earth's rotation came to a halt,
has declared all of North America a disaster area.
Fellow Americans, to come together.
The world called on the one man who could make a difference.
Oh. This is fake.
When it happened again, the world
this called is like a meta trailer.
Yeah.
No one saw it coming. 3 more
times. This is from what's that movie?
Now, the one man who made a difference 5 times before.
Tropic Thunder.
Is about to make a difference. Again. Only this time.
Alright, doesn't count.
Who left the fridge?
Beansy, I'm giving it 0.
Tug Speedman. Scorcher 6. Global Meltdown. Here we go again. Again.
You don't think that's worthy of voting on?
No, it's fake.
It's not real. It's all right. Here, let me argue in favor. It's a trailer, and we're trailer boys.
It's not. It's a parody of a trailer.
Okay. All right. Point making. Okay, suspicious black light stain, problematic. Oh, I don't have problematic on this screen. Whoops, it'll show up next time, I'm sure. Okay, well, if we're not voting on that, apologize.
Here.
that's my bad. All right, do you want to pick another one, or you want me to go? Because I got
one. Yeah, I'm gonna pick another one. I got one.
Fine. Oh, I just realized that this category is prime for your favorite genre of movie, which is religious.
It's Operator 134, what city, please? Is that a business or residence?
What's her name? That's not Andy McDowell, is it? It's...
No.
I heard someone talking about...
I like
about
the vibe.
Who's the boy?
Some people say that he's a prophet.
Some people say there's others like him, all around the country.
All around the world.
Mimi Rogers.
Yeah. Don't you know what's going on?
What?
The dream.
Dragon Ball tattoo?
If everybody's getting this dream, how come it isn't on the news?
Those who need to know, know. Those who don't believe won't get the dream.
World's a disaster.
We have no power to make it better.
There has to be something more.
Let me help you.
Dukov! Long-haired Dukov!
If I tell you, you're not going to believe me.
At the end of days.
There are wars and rumors of wars, Mommy. And a curse devours the earth. And those who live in it are held guilty.
All who believe will be raised up. All who doubt will be cast down. And at the gates of heaven, all will be forgiven. All but
this
one.
This is like a knockoff of The Stand.
The Rapture.
Yo, that looked cool as shit.
That
it could be a religious movie, and it could. That's the thing. If religious movies were packaged like that, like, you know, it looked interesting enough.
Yeah,
I'd watch that. I've never heard of that before. That was cool.
Have you heard of it? You know, I bet that trailer, I bet that movie. Like, there's a good chance it's really slow and kind of boring and nothing really happens. But I loved the trailer.
Yeah, no, that's classic Trailer Boys stuff. It's like where it's a good enough trailer where you're like, I would say a movie, but it's like the movie could be shit, you know? But it was interesting.
That did its job for me. I really dug that one.
It kind of gave me like... The Cell vibes. Remember The Cell?
Yeah. The Inkle comic series by John Gerard has a unofficial movie trailer that is really crazy. If you guys don't know him, he worked with Jodorowsky on the Scrap Dune adaptation, which is what ended up becoming The Inkle. He also worked on movies like Alien and Tron doing set design and was a huge inspiration for Star Wars.
Terminal Passage, I would say, remember that.
He used to wear his herring buns.
That got a 64% yes, meaning 2 points.
2 points. That's also 2 points from me.
That's also 2 points for me. That is a 6-point trailer. That's good. I like to start off with a good. Well, you know, we had one trip up, but you know, I like Lindsay. Yeah. Who submitted that?
That was Schwingles.
Schwingles. What was it called?
The Rapture.
Oh, cool! Good job, Schwingles. I vibe that. It's an interesting one. All right. This is one I haven't seen, but a lot of people have told me about this. Skarsgårds, plural. Justine and
Mike. Never seen you look so happy.
Enjoy it while it lasts. I myself hate marriages.
She ruined my wedding. I will not look at her.
Is everybody in your family start raving mad?
I thought you really wanted this, but I do. What star is that?
Melancholy is just gonna pass right in front of us, and it's gonna be the most beautiful sight ever.
Hey,
said there's nothing to do.
Then he's forgotten about the magic.
It looks cool.
I want us to be together when it happens.
Is this Lars von Trier or something?
Yeah. A friend of mine called Lars von Trier's movies depression porn. I'm like, yeah, it's kind of.
It looks cool.
See, the
funny thing is, continue.
See, let's see who can like guess the running length of that movie. Nate, what's your guess for how long that movie is?
3 hours long.
I'm going to guess over 3 hours. I'm going to say like 3:15.
Poll is live.
Let's see. Melancholia. Oh, 2 hours and 15 minutes. All right, so it's not that long.
The only thing I know about that movie is I remember when he was in Cannes doing PR for it, and he was like saying some stuff that could be misinterpreted. He was saying some I forget what it was, but I think he got kicked out of Cannes for what he said. Or maybe he did say, I don't remember the details, but it was some sketchy shit. Oh, was he a Nazi? Is that what it was? Uh-huh. It was something, he was saying something Nazi shit, and then like Kristen's like, they're not gonna understand. I just remember seeing like the clip of her being like, shut up, they're not gonna understand what you're saying. And I thought that was kind of funny. Oh, that's what it is. Alright, True Harm says he said that he understands Hitler and got banned from Cannes for 7 years. Sorry, bud. Yeah. Alright, that got 61% yes. So that is 2 points from chat. I thought it looked really cool, but it wasn't like I didn't really understand what the movie was about. Like half the trailer was at a wedding, you know?
Yeah, it's a wedding like and the world's gonna end.
Meh. 1 point. 1 point because visually it looked neat.
Looked neat and everything. No points. Boring.
Okay. So 2 points of chat, 1 point from Nate. 3 points total that came from Hendo. Hendo. Hendo's the one who's like, oh, he's a Nazi. Like, yeah, you knew about him. All right, hold on.
We're going. Ready?
Yep, we're in.
This doesn't seem right. Oh, no, yeah, right.
Every 700,000 years, the world is devastated by an event of catastrophic proportions. Oceans boil. Continents freeze. Poles shift. And species are destroyed by a single mysterious force. As of today, we are 100,000 years overdue.
The core of the Earth has stopped spinning. The spinning core protects us from cosmic radiation.
Without it,
radiation will create superstorms. Microwaves will literally cook our planet. After that, it gets bad. So, how do we fix it? We can't. What if we could?
We're here about your legendary ship.
What would it take to get it in 3 months?
Enigmatic Booty Bandit says this is basically Scorcher.
You take a check?
Yeah.
Can't wait to go to the center of the Earth, detonate 1,000 megatons of nuclear weapons, and we outrun the biggest nuclear shockwave in history.
We're going in.
This is molten iron at 9,000 degrees Fahrenheit. 2,000 miles down, 1,000 miles thick. Millions of pounds of pressure.
We've got a breach!
10 seconds.
Go to full throttle.
Do it! Ah!
The audio of that sucked. Did you hear the scratchiness?
Yeah, yeah. I don't know. Well, like it's funny that that was like this like film transfer. It seems like a relic from the 70s, you know?
Yeah. You think it was like a filter they put on it to make it look older? It's some kid who's like, I found this old trailer from 2003. Whoops, I wrote Paul. I always get the core and the sphere confused. And I was like, when does Dustin Hoffman get here? Not the same movie.
I thought that was really fun. I think that beginning part, maybe it's in the movie, but I like to think that that's something that's like specifically in the trailer. And I love that shit.
The core? I don't know. That movie just seemed dumb.
Yeah, but no, no. Like, it all seemed these dumb. Real actors I, in, I, but I was like, the Tooch wig, that was really great.
Tooch, yeah, it was. It was like a nod to like his future performance in Hunger Games.
Yeah,
had the what was his name in Hunger Games? He had a great name. Principal roles resubscribed for 15 months. A lot of 15 month anniversaries tonight. Big ups to you guys. There's got to be real science behind it, though, right?
I also love lines where it's like, we can't do this, but what if we could?
Yeah, why not?
I think it's like the funniest kind of like movie, kind of like, but the science isn't there, but what if it was?
What if we figured it out? What if we get a train that drills downward into the core? I don't remember shit. I know I've seen that movie. I don't remember shit about that movie. All right. That got a 51% yes. So 2 points from chat. I'm going to give it... I like the trailer. It's like in my vibe. And there are trailers I don't like. So I'm still going to give that a point because I feel like it's... Like, that's like a very, that's like my baseline of like, yes, this is what I'll give a point to. So I kind of want to give it a point just to establish where my points are going, right?
I'm going to give it 2 points for this reason. It does not look like a good movie, but it was a good trailer.
Okay.
I think the trailer was better than the movie, you know?
Yeah, okay. I'm not going to give it 2 points because of that, but I will give it 1 point for the same, for sold me on that.
I have a sweet spot for trailers that seem like we're not watching the movie. Like, the first half of the trailer doing that thing, like, maybe it is.
Maybe it is in the movie.
In the movie, maybe there is a part from it, but it definitely seems like we weren't watching the movie at first, and then we got into the movie, and I like that.
Yeah, I like that. I like that. Okay, so that is 5 points.
5 points.
We've been doing some new trailers. All right.
Let's see. What's that one?
Who submitted that?
The core was Prof. Marth.
Professor Marth, back on the board, sir. Welcome to Trailer Boys. Dr. Butthugger says, I miss when trailers had 45 seconds of bullshit and 10 seconds of actually movie footage. I kind of like that. What I hate now is the pre-trailer trailer where they show you a trailer for the trailer. That's bullshit. All right, here's my choice.
I'm going to tell you the story of the journey down the road not taken.
The Jeremy?
This is the way the world ends. This is the way the world ends. These are the sordid tales of how it all came crashing.
Is it Justin Timberlake?
Yeah.
It is?
This is an epic Los Angeles crime saga.
And you're researching your role?
Yes, it takes place in the near future.
Scientists are saying the future is going to be far more futuristic than they originally predicted.
You're gonna have to wear a bulletproof vest.
I love The Rock.
Let's talk about
Dwayne Johnson.
What's it really about?
I saw this movie.
You're not really
I don't
here.
Remember Gone any
so
of this.
I'm scared, Mr. Centauros. The future is just like you imagine.
Someone must be hiding it.
It's like the nervous breakdown of the century.
Nothing that a killer, a porn star, and a tattoo parlor can't handle.
It is time for a surgical strike.
Is that Sherry or Terry?
I'm a pimp, and pimps don't commit suicide. It all ends.
That is this movie.
It's a strange one.
It had to be this way.
I know.
There'd be a lot less violence in the world if everyone just got a little more cardio.
What?
Music by Moby.
What? What? Okay. Let me just say this. I was like, South of Tales, and this is a movie that, like, back when Netflix had, like, nothing, it would be suggested to me all the time, South of Tales, and I was like, no! No, and I would just skip by it all the time, and it just, like, because it kept asking me to watch it, I just refused, and so I just never watched it out of, like, you know, whatever. That's not what I thought it was about, you know. And then two, I'm like, oh, it is about the end of the world. And then, like, the rest of the trailer, you're like, wait, how? What? What is? I don't know what's going on. Will you explain that?
I saw it and I don't know what's going on, you know? Like, it's like if Richard Kelly was like, you know what, Donnie Darko kind of made too much sense. And everyone else is like, no.
All right, Punish Waller says, during a 3-day heat wave just before a huge 4th of July celebration, an action star stricken with amnesia meets up with a porn star who is developing her own reality TV project and a policeman who holds the key to the vast conspiracy. What the fuck?
The movie doesn't make sense because there's prequel graphic novels that set a lot of the movie.
Can you still get the graphic novels? Oh man, that is crazy. Well,
prequel graphic novels that set up the movie. Like, you go see the movie because you're like, well, this is the popular thing.
Yeah. You don't want homework, you know, to see a movie.
Like, we see it and they're like, all right, I don't get it. And they're like, oh, well, you should read the graphic novels. And it's like,
you didn't
well,
do
fuck
your movie homework.
Right?
Yeah. Like, that got 2 points from Chat Sam.
I'll give it a point. It was shiny objects.
I'm not going to give it... Here's the thing. As a trailer, I like it. All right? It's silly, and it has people I like in it. And it's just a perfect little clip of, like, the 90s or 2000s, I guess, maybe. But it didn't feel on theme to me. Nothing about that felt, like, cataclysmic or, you know, apocalyptic.
No, he said the world was going to end. This is about the world ending. This is how the world ends. That's how the trailer starts out.
Yeah. But then, I don't know. It just seemed like not part of it. So I'm not going to give it a point. two from chat, one from Sam.
One from Sam, yeah.
And that came to us from Deja Nintendo. Sorry, Deja. Of the movies we watched so far, that's the one I'm like, I have to see this now. But I do want to read the comic books. So if anyone can hit me with some links in the Discord, that'll be great. Thank you very much. We do have a Discord. Why Do Skids have a Discord? Here.
Yeah.
And you click about, and you can join the Discord. And Trailer Boys have our own channel.
Yeah.
All right, Sam, you got something?
Oh, wait, no.
All right, I guess we'll watch.
Give me one second.
You know what's funny? Talking about Donnie Darko, I saw that like in the theater, in this tiny indie theater in Boston, and it was only in the theater for one weekend. It was like 3 days, and a friend was like, I'm friends with the guy that worked on this movie. He's like, we should go see it. And there was like no one there. And then it got like all that heat afterwards, and it came back in the theater, and we went and saw it again. And we were like, oh, it's so cool. The music was great. Blah, blah. It's such a weird movie. And since then, like, the more I watched it, the more I was like, wait, does none of this make sense? And like, the more I hated it. But it's like other friends, like, as my interest was going down, I had friends that were like getting really into it and seeing it for the first time, and I was like, no, you shouldn't like this. And like, explaining to them like why they shouldn't like it. So
this is Dr. Jacob Glazer, and I'm reporting from Stonehenge. Believe me when I tell you, I'm not making this up. I can see that the stones have moved. And the big question is how and why the government is quarantining the area.
Is that the guy from the core?
Energy from the blast is channeled deep underground.
Smishmashman stand.
Mexico was devastated by a volcanic eruption in Yucatan.
You don't think a simultaneous eruption is connected?
We need to know what is going on right here, not 5,000 miles away.
You are the chosen few who will seed this earth with a pure spirit.
Does anyone have an idea how to neutralize this?
This is the image that I picked up of the EM field in the altar stone. The mechanism is some sort of electromagnetic key.
To turn off Stonehenge?
Sends the debate on whether or not Stonehenge is causing disasters.
What now?
We're getting the mechanism.
Wait.
Get out of here!
Is that the guy from the Constantine television show?
A nuclear strike will destroy the entire planet.
I will not gamble the fate of this world on a museum piece.
Misha. No, he's from Supernatural.
Oh, he plays, yeah.
The stones are siphoning the Earth's energy grid.
Which means what?
Are you ready for the new dawn?
Stonehenge Apocalypse was the fucking name of that movie. Hold on. I just gotta watch like the last like 10 seconds of that or whatever.
Sends the debate on whether or not Stonehenge is causing disaster.
This guy's from something too. Would anyone recognize this guy?
Sends the debate on whether
this guy, anyone recognize that guy?
He looks like the guy that gets the like crazy contraption on his dick from Seven, but it's not him.
Highlander?
No, it's Stonehenge. He's causing disasters.
What now? Yeah.
We're getting the mechanism.
That guy's from Supernatural.
A nuclear strike plays will like destroy the entire planet.
Gabriel,
I will not
something.
Gamble the fate of this world on a museum piece.
Oh my god!
What's that guy from?
Which guy?
The Hill Harper.
He's from a doctor show.
Stone is siphoning the Earth's energy grid.
Which means what?
Are you ready for the new dawn?
This is awesome. With the fucking pyramids. That was so great. Oh man.
Oh, he's from The Good Doctor. He's from CSNY. CSINY.
Wow. The Haunting of Hill Harper? Is that... anyway, sorry. Stonehenge Apocalypse. Like, the movie writes itself once you get the title, right?
I mean... It looks like the most boring movie because it's like they're like, something's happening at Stonehenge. Oh my god, what's happening? It's causing the end of the world. What? And they're like, I guess this ends the debate on whether or not Stonehenge is causing the apocalypse. It's like, what? What is ending the debate? Like, what happened? Like,
Do you think these people that are like, you know, act like the supernatural and the guy from The Good Doctor were in this before they were in those other shows? Or is this like their first movie and they're like, yeah, I'm in this fucking dope sci-fi movie. And then they realize they have like a Neil Breen like effects budget. When the pyramids opened up and like started shooting like nukes, that was like...
I think they probably were aware. I think they were like, oh,
this is hot garbage. And I will give it a point, baby. Because, like...
I think they might have thought it was better than it was going to be, but I bet they knew it was going to be bad.
I guess it's tough when you don't know what the effects are like. So you're in a movie, like a lot of those movies where you're like, I'm acting, I'm doing my acting thing. And you're like, I hope it looks good when they finish it. You can assume, you know? Like 300 could have ended up like that, you know? Like, that got... 69%, yes. They got very close to 3 points. So I got 2 points from chat. And I'm giving it a point. Hot garbage.
I'll give it a point. Man. I love the effects.
Yeah, I mean, that's just kind of... It's so weird to me that how much a movie can hinge on that. Because it's like, good effects change everything, you know?
A lot
of different things go into making a movie.
Here's the thing is they go into that knowing who's making the movie. Like, they know it's not Universal making the movie, you know? Yeah.
But I wonder, like, if you saw Independence Day, right? And it had like, mm-hmm. you know, those desktop computer kind of like effects. Like, it would have been a completely different movie. Do you think this movie, with, like, some real big budget effects, would have been better? Or do you think it's hot garbage from birth?
Would have been better. I mean, and, like, you know, like, the core is basically that. The core is a movie that could have been, like, super, super, super bad, but, like... there is no plot. Like, I think it's hot garbage from birth in that, like, I don't think it would have ever been able to raise a budget that would have, you know, like, that would have been able to save it.
Lobaka has a point, though, saying Amazing Bulk would not have been as good with better effects.
True.
Yeah, because it's basically Ang Lee's... Jesus Christ. Is that behind you?
What?
Is there somebody behind you?
No.
Are they behind me? Something came through on the green screen, like right in this area.
Oh, was it? I moved my mic?
You. Maybe. I got scared, looked behind me, and I'm like, oh, wait, that's not me.
Oh, yeah, I think it was. I moved my mic.
Thu Jeans, or the W Jeans... I don't know how to pronounce it, has also resubscribed for 15 months. Wow. Pretty interesting. We got a lot of people going on here. El Moselle has resubscribed for 7 months. Thank you very much. Corncob Jenkins has gifted a tier one sub to Dr. Butthugger. Yeah, working together. Dr. Butthugger. Fun name to say. And I can pronounce it. Okay, so you put the points on that one.
What was it, 4 points?
I gave it a point. Chat gave it 2 points.
I gave it a point.
Yeah, Lobaka says, there's a charm of a bad movie with $20 budget trying its best. More money doesn't fix that, just loses charm. I feel I don't like it when the movies like know they're gonna be schlocky and shitty. I like when they're trying. So anyway.
Yeah.
Beep pop boop pop.
I mean that's, well, we're not talking about that, right? We're not
talking. Wait, no, that's the wrong trailer, sorry.
I'm going to
What are we talking about?
We're not talking about like, you know, like Incredible Bulk being amazing because it's so bad and like it's so fun to watch. We're talking about like just the quality of a movie looking, you know, I don't know.
Paul Walker's brother has a good point and says, just look at Fast and the Furious. You would say that. It's Paul Walker's brother.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Let's see if I did the right one.
You and
I'm excited for this.
Together forever. The theory of randomness says it's all simply
coincidence. The
there is no grand meaning, making it possible for you to be sitting here in this riveting lecture.
50 years ago, the students of William Dawes Elementary imagined what the future might hold. Today, we unveiled their legacy.
Okay, why are you showing me this?
It's a list of dates.
Every major global disaster for the last 50 years in perfect sequence.
A piece of paper that's been buried in the ground for 5 decades.
Why would you say 50 years?
The next number on the chain predicts that tomorrow, 81 people are going to die in some kind of tragedy.
Get off the train.
Why? What's wrong?
Just take the baby and get off the train.
Why would he stay on the train?
Estimates put the presumed dead at 81.
Prediction came true.
What?
Coincidence. Don't let him watch the news.
Why won't you tell me what's going on? They were here.
Who?
The Whisperer people.
What do you want with my son?
The numbers are a warning. They're a warning to everyone.
Is that Rose Byrne?
Yeah.
This is an emergency broadcast transmission.
Can someone in chat tell me how old Rose Byrne is? She's looked the same
to stay on
for
the
like 30
as
years.
As possible.
Are we gonna die?
I like her.
I will never let that happen, Caleb. Do you hear me? Never.
I feel like I got this movie confused in my head. Because I'm like, I've seen this movie, and it's silly.
It's fucking crazy.
Does he have another movie that's very similar to this? Because I'm like, I don't remember that movie.
That movie is really silly. I like...
Not Ghost Rider.
I mean, you might... There is another movie that came out like right around then. Where it, instead of it being about him finding this list of dates, he is a stuntman who gets like cursed and gets his skull becomes fire. It's called Ghost Rider.
Oh yeah.
So yeah, is it Ghost Rider that you're thinking of?
No, I'm not thinking of Jim Carrey's 23. It was I thought it was all right. So Nicolas Cage is a magician, and he can like. See the future, but only a little bit, and there's like a ferry boat involved, and there's like a cop.
Oh, wait. I know that one. Yes.
Can I Toko 4-1-4-1-4?
It's.
Next. Well, Deja had it. Next.
It's called. Somebody else it's say. Called Ghost Rider Spirit of Vengeance.
It is next. I thought this was next. It's not.
Yeah, it's not. No, that movie is batshit though. Knowing is fucking crazy.
So who are like, the people in the...
You can't tell how... Do you want to know the ending?
Hold on. Yes.
We're going to tell the ending. We're going to tell the ending. Okay. So, like, there's all, like, the numbers and shit like that. And then, like, I think the number becomes, like, there's some number he doesn't realize what's going on. And it because it's the numbers, he realizes the number's so high because it's the whole world blows up. And those people are, I think, are, like, a people of, like, an alien race who are, like taking the kid to like preserve humanity.
So the people in the woods were like aliens?
I think so, yeah. Because the world blows up. The whole world ends at the end of that movie.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Cool.
Is that true? Yes. Yes, it is true.
Well, I mean, a lot of these like world ending movies, the world doesn't actually end, you know? Anyway, spoiler over.
Yeah, the whole world blows up at the end of it. Yeah.
All right. Now spoilers are over. Wow. Somebody just muted and unmuted as you said the whole world blows up at the end of the movie. Sorry. Ruined knowing for you. Anyway.
They just did it again. You just did it. If they missed it. You just did it like really hard.
All right. We're getting better. We're getting better. All right, so Chad gave that 2 points. I want to see that movie now. I'm going to give it 2 points.
It did what it's supposed to do, right? No, I'm going to give it a point.
All right, just because you don't think it's worth 6 points?
Because I liked the movie. I love, like, a crazy bad trailer. But, like, I feel like that trailer's too misleading. Like, the trailer, like, if I wasn't here and had seen the movie and been like, hey, that movie's crazy, you wouldn't know that the movie's crazy.
Based on what? Based on the trailer, the movie looks crazy. Yeah. But you're saying the movie's not crazy?
No, I'm saying that like, it took me to tell you that, like, no, the movie's, like, crazier than you think.
So it's not that misleading. It's just underselling it.
Yeah, I think they undersold it.
Okay. All right. I won't question it. All right, so that is a 5-point trailer, and that's going to... AvalancheFan84, one of the top 10 from season 1, back on the board. Okay, you got something?
Yes.
Your dad fucked with Nick Cage. Did he find out? Did he fuck around and get found out? Hold on, everyone, I got a match. Do you remember after, never mind.
You ready?
Yep.
An extraordinary book is about to come to life as an unforgettable motion picture. It's the story of Jim and Hilda.
Hello, dear.
Is this like French? Hello, love.
Did you have a nice morning, dear?
Oh, all right, thanks. Rather uneventful.
Two kind, well, simple people living on trust and hope.
It'll take more than a few bombs to get me down.
The Prime Minister, speaking a few minutes ago in the House of Commons, has warned that the international situation is deteriorating rapidly.
Crumbs.
Could break out.
What's the matter, dear? Have you burned yourself?
This is it, Dux.
Civil defense
measures. This is really it.
But now they're caught up in events which will change our world.
I love the voiceover.
Just you be careful, Jay.
An enemy missile attack has been launched.
Oh, dear. I've left the oven on.
Get in, get in, get in.
The cake will be served.
So long, child. It's all.
when the wind blows.
It's pretty dark. Wow. Roger
Waters. That was cool. Yeah, Roger Waters does the music for it, and has a song by David Bowie. The animation style was cool. It looked like that was like early computer animation or something. Like there was the shot of the airplane and the shot of the submarine did not look cel shade.
How long do you think that movie is? Because I'd be surprised if that was like feature length. It looked like you saw like the whole thing pretty much.
It's a sad movie, apparently.
It felt very Roger Waters-like. Yeah, was he like a producer? Did he write it? His name was on the end, but it was too blurry. I couldn't really see. Hold on. Let's see what that says. Film score by Roger Waters.
84 minutes.
84 minutes? What do they do for 84 minutes in that movie? You think like 20 minutes of it is just them being like an old married couple?
Yeah, probably.
They just said that's a watch party movie for sure. Possibly. It seems dark. It seems pretty depressing.
I thought that was.
We should do 50 minutes of them making tea. Wow. Chat gave that 3 points.
I give it 2 points.
I mean, I'm at 1 point. Because it's just like, I don't know. Again, like, I'm giving 1 point because I'm like, I can't imagine that being a movie longer than the trailer.
It does look like it is the beginning of Up the movie.
Who said like, that?
Just, let's see. Rex Bosworth. Champion of Man.
Is that his name?
That's their name.
Oh, Rex Bosworth, Champion of Man. It's a long name.
Yeah, it's a reference to a Whitehead sketch. Mm.
Why do I know the name Rex Bosworth? I was thinking Rex Manning.
Rex Manning Day, Empire Records.
Rex Manning Day. I love Empire Records. What theme would we do? Like, if we wanted to watch Empire Records, what would the theme be?
Hello? Sorry.
Hello? Did I cut out? Sorry. If we were to watch Empire Records, what would the theme be?
You could do ensemble cast, or you could do movies about a place.
Aren't all casts ensemble, though?
I mean, no.
Okay. I've got one here.
Like a you think Castaway is an ensemble cast?
It's an ensemble of one.
Yeah,
but like any movie that has no, yeah, you're right. That's not. But like any movie that has like more than one person, right? Anyway, I feel it's too wide of a theme.
I think an ensemble cast refers to like, you know, a cast of a lot of characters that all kind of, but we could do movies about places. That's, you know, like
movies that take place at work, movies at a job.
A lot of Altman films are movies about places where like the place is the character, you know?
Okay. All right, that's one to workshop. All right, you ready?
Okay.
Did you ever wonder what it would be like to be one of the last people on Earth?
We're talking ghost town!
Who would you see?
There's nobody. I mean, there's nobody.
What would you do?
Hey, I'm sorry if the end of the world makes me a little nervous.
Where would you go?
The stars are up!
Well, get ready to find out, because the comet is coming into your orbit.
The legal drinking age is now 10, but you will need ID. Let's be real.
It's the night of the comet.
What do you give me if I come back?
Texas.
Night of the comet.
I'll be taking requests from all you teenage comet zombies.
The night the teenagers ruled the world.
Yeah!
Night of the comet.
The burden of civilization is on us.
Fiction, isn't it?
That is a dope cover. Right?
Yeah.
That is rad.
Wait.
There, you can do it.
Go to 57 seconds.
It's a short trailer.
Nation is on us.
Fiction, isn't it?
Is that Dear Evan Hansen?
Isn't it? Fiction, isn't it?
Nation is on us.
Fiction, isn't it?
Right?
Yeah. Yeah. I have a friend that has this theory, and she's like, they stop making new people. And she will just post pictures of, like, people that look alike that everyone gets confused, you know? And it's, like, it's pretty funny. She's like, yeah, they stop making new people. Like, if you see, what's that British lady? She's a hot, older British lady, and she's in that new...
Queen Elizabeth?
No, she, somebody tell me. Thatcher. Judi Dench. No, Judi Dench is not hot. She's the hot British lady. And she's Helen Mirren. Thank you, Doc McGrizzle. Yeah. Thank you, Doc McGrizzle. All right. Helen Mirren, younger, looks just like Jennifer Hunger Games.
J-Law? Jennifer Lawrence?
Jennifer Lawrence. Hold on. Let me see this. I didn't set up a rabbit hole scene tonight, which usually... all right. Helen Mirren. Jennifer Lawrence. It's crazy. Okay.
It's...
Hold on.
It's not that crazy.
That's Helen Mirren when she was young, right? There. Right. Anyway, you can do your own research.
I mean, basically what you're saying is that, like...
They stop making new people.
Jennifer Lawrence could play Helen Mirren in something.
What's that French Toast Ken guy? the big YouTube guy? We kind of look alike. Or people say that, I don't really know. Anyway... what was that called? Going back, that was called Night of the Comet. That seemed fun.
Night of the Comet. Right? That's a cool movie. Yeah, I've seen like the end half of that. That's a total like Pluto TV movie.
I just love Pluto the whole TV. Like teenagers take over the world.
Pluto TV, our unofficial sponsor. Watch Pluto.
Yeah. If you work at Pluto TV or you're doing research for potential sponsorships, you know, you got us right now. Sponsor us, Pluto TV, because we endorse you. I watch so much of the Star Trek channel, Pluto TV. It is great. They have a film noir channel. I like the 90s movie channel,
80s movie channel, 70s movie channel. It's great to just bounce around between those three.
I will say this: right. If you're like me, well, we're still doing the vote. I'm gonna give it a 1 point because it was just fun, but it just wasn't.
Yeah, enough. I'm gonna give it 1 point too.
But for Pluto TV, Sam and I have been talking about this for a while, and I was like, I can get any movie I want. I can watch whatever movie. All these streaming services make their own stuff. You know, the key hook on Pluto TV is what we miss with all these streaming services. Sometimes I'll like look for a movie or a TV show for like half an hour, and then watch it and then, you know, fall asleep or something because I've been looking at shit so long. Pluto TV is just channels of live stuff. And you just jump in where you jump in. And there are commercials, but they're not as crazy as like TV commercials, you know, where it's like every 10 minutes, there's 10 minutes of commercials. So highly suggest checking out
Pluto TV. Uncensored movies. Like, you know, like they're uncut, uncensored, full movies.
Yeah, that's the thing. Dark McGrizzle, yeah. You say, isn't like cable, but cable now has crazy commercials and they're truncated to fit time slots.
Yeah. Also, here's the thing. You gotta pay for cable. Pluto TV's free.
All right, Night of the Comet came to us from Count Pupper, and that gets 4 points.
All right, here's Sam. This one's like on theme with Night of the Comet, I think.
Love can sure spin your head around. God, where do you begin?
Well, hello.
We must have been meant to be together.
Oh man, her hair looks awful. Too bad you have to work tonight.
Only till midnight.
Fate is a funny thing.
Take a nap, because you're going to need all your energy tonight.
It was one of those strange nights.
Finally meet the right girl and you blow it.
That could ruin your whole day. In a big way.
It's happening. This is it. This is really it. This is the big one.
This is a joke, right?
It's really happening.
It's just went black and white. I like that. I like this.
It can't be true. We'll all be dead if we don't get out of here. Nobody believes this, do they?
That diner's still there, but I think it's closed.
People who would want to bring along.
We gotta get Julie.
Who's Julie?
Harry Belafonte.
Who are you?
Who are you?
Stop and let me off.
I don't stop for nothing. Jump!
Don't hurt me, man. I got Nakamichi Pioneer. I got everything. If it doesn't happen, I'll tell you, if what doesn't happen, man.
I'm dreaming. That's it, I'm dreaming.
Y'all ready to go? You the pilot?
Hey, you know anybody who can
fly helicopter? Helicopter pilot.
All the helicopter pilot bars are closed.
What's the problem?
It's true. Love can be exciting.
Trust me with this.
Even terrifying.
Julie!
Leave me out! I love you.
But nothing could prepare you for an experience like
that. That guy always looked old, huh?
What is it, Jim Perry?
Miracle Mile.
Listen, I'm just a guy who picked up the phone.
So that the area, the neighborhood in Los Angeles is named after this movie?
Yep. Yep.
Hold on. I want to go over a thing here when the gun goes off.
Quote, what's the problem?
It's true. Love can be exciting.
Trust me with this.
They shoot the gun and his whole arm catches on fire. I love that.
Maybe it's covered in gas.
Yeah.
Even terrifying.
So this guy it's funny seeing this guy in this because he looks the same, and I mean he must
he was be like in a
Kurt Fuller.
Yeah, he was in a oh man, the poster for this is awesome.
Oh really?
That guy is from Wayne's World.
For an experience like this.
Oh, that's a rad poster.
Listen, I'm just a guy who can pick up the phone.
I love how he's like, he didn't, it, you know, I haven't seen the movie, but it's not like, and it's not like he's a scientist. He's like just the guy that picked up the phone. So imagine like being out somewhere and you're like, somebody's like, the world's ending, and you're like, okay, got it, done. And he's like, I'm just the guy that picked up the phone. Are you on IMDb looking at posters?
It's the poster on IMDb for the movie, yes.
All right, hold on. Let me check my IMDb scene before I show everyone my email.
Uh, And did you see Denise Crosby was in there?
Who's Denise Crosby?
She, you might know her from a TV show called Star Trek The Next Generation.
Tasha Yar?
Tasha Yar.
No way.
Yeah, that's funny. Also
this is a cool poster, dude.
Cemetery. Yeah, isn't that rad?
Yeah, this is a poster. So, Alamo Drafthouse, like, people know Alamo Drafthouse from their, it's not Ollie North, Ollie something, but he did these, like, crazy Star Wars posters, and they got super sold out. I think Timmy might have one of them, but they're crazy Star Wars posters. But they would do, it's, you know, Alamo Drafthouse, before they were, like, the production company and stuff, would do these, like, screen-printed posters of, like, weird movies no one had seen. And this is the kind of thing, like, I was collecting all these, like, super weird posters. Sam, you gave me a bunch of cool ones, and I don't know where they went. You gave me the Benji poster. That was rad. And then the Poltergeist poster was pretty gnarly, too. I think those were Polish. Mondo.
Yeah, I was way into Polish movie posters for a while.
Yeah, Pivotal Pete is right. Mondo. Beansy, we were doing the eBay on stream while we waited. We were going for it, and I got outbid at literally 1 second left by $5. So, sucks. But we're going to try again. We got a few more donations. Again, Beansy was a big contributor. I'll put it in the link. Secret Santa, I think, was it? Secret Santa. If I can spell Secret Santa. All right. Yeah, this movie poster is cool as shit, dude. I'm just the guy that picked up the phone.
Yeah.
See, that movie poster sucks. But the other one was cool.
I mean...
I mean, like, the main online one. But, like, this one I'm looking at right now on stream looks dumb. Like, who thought this was better? No. Yellow one? Yeah.
The yellow one. Yeah. Sorry, I'm looking with the delay. The one where it's like the photo of all the cars blowing up in the streets, pretty cool.
This one's hilarious though too.
Not as good.
Let me see. Poll. I forgot to put the poll up. Sorry, guys. Miracle Mile. Yes. No. I'm going to give Miracle Mile a point. It looked fun. It looked interesting. It looked weird.
I'm giving it 2 points. I loved it.
Why 2 points?
Because I loved it. I loved the trailer. I thought it was, like, weird and had a cool style to it. It was fun.
Her hair looks really bad.
Had a lot of crazy actors in it. Fun seeing that. It's a well-crafted trailer. Who's that other guy that...
Olan Jones? That's a pretty interesting name. You know what? I'm on the bubble. I'm going to give it a point. Like, there's something that... Chad gave it 3 points.
I'm giving it 2, yeah.
I got to give it 1. Who
Peter Berg's in that movie.
The director, Peter Berg?
Yeah, he plays a band member in something. Brian Thompson is that fake Arnold Schwarzenegger guy who also played the punk in The Terminator and was the villain in the Stallone movie Cobra.
I thought that was The Edge.
That was in that trailer? No. Ooh, Edward Bunker's in that movie. It just has everyone.
Who's Edward Bunker?
He's Mr. Blue in Reservoir Dogs. He's a writer.
Oh, no shit.
Earl Bowen, who was also in Terminator 2, as the guy that ran the psych ward.
This movie's called Pass the Ammo. We gotta. Oh wait, hold on. While we're here, while we're IMDBing, because we, Roland, how do you say Emmerich?
Yeah, should we do our Roland Emmerich deep dive?
Yeah. That was your pick, though, right? So make sure you put the points in there for Miracle Mile. That was 5 points. So wait, we talked about Roland Emmerich. I gave it 1 point. Oh, yeah, yeah, it was 6 points. Chuck gave it 3. Let me see. Should we do... What do you consider more Roland Emmerich of a movie? A writing credit or a directing credit?
I want to say directing credit. Okay. But someone submitted one of Roland Emmerich's early ones, so I think we could start with that and throw down the points if...
Okay. Do you want to... Do you want to cue it up? Do you know what it was?
Yeah.
Understand.
Making contact.
But Joey won't be helpless for long. Joey! Because Joey's not alone anymore. Making contact. An out of this world adventure.
Making contact. Yeah.
Now it's so it's a Roland Emmerich movie. I mean, whoever put it in must have heard us talking about it because we were talking about this last week. Schwingle has another Roland Emmerich suck up.
Oh, is that a Schwingle submission?
No. That was Gasfire, who actually was the one who submitted Miracle Mile.
Transition. Yeah.
I'm not going to give that any points. I like that it's like it's in the Roland Emmerich deep dive, but it doesn't fit the theme. So,
okay. We won't vote on it. It's funny, though, like that's 86 that had like a little bit of every, you know, that was very. What year did Close Encounters come out?
I think it came out in 1989. I think it came out in 1999.
Close Encounters of the Third Kind came out in 99?
Yeah. Look it up. It's on IMDb. Yeah.
Oh, you just wanted me to look it up. Touche. So Close Encounters was 77, and then Poltergeist came out in 82. This just had like a lot of stuff that like
E.T.
E.T.
It was so weird, 82. This trailer. It was so weird. That like it's like now Joey's not gonna be picked on anymore because he's not alone.
Yeah, what does that mean? He's not alone. Is that like because that was the doll part of it? Like, all right, starts off. All right, I just want to go back now that we've seen it too.
It's definitely an E.T. bite.
Yeah.
Over here.
This is very E.T.-ish.
Growing up can be hell.
His parents especially died?
When you're different.
Yes, dad.
So it's like they're searching for, like, they're searching for something, right?
They're searching for an alien, probably.
But it goes right to a funeral scene?
Yeah. But also the link of, like, growing up can be hell, like...
Growing up can be hell.
Whoever died is especially in hell.
When you're different.
So then you're like, oh, he's got, like, some powers, some stuff,
when
right?
You're helpless.
But then also, like, oh, wait, no, he doesn't have powers. It's like a poltergeist possessing a puppet. All of a sudden, we're in, like, something else now. And alone.
He's psychic or something, and when he grows into his psychicness, he becomes a portal to the underworld. Ah.
Supernatural forces.
But, like, what's happening now? Like, who the fuck?
He can't understand.
I don't understand.
Yeah.
And now it's like poltergeists, like ET, Close Encounters shit.
Because Joey's not alone anymore. World adventure.
It's not aliens. His dad dies and he makes contact with Ghost Dad and the doll summons demons. What? Thanks,
there's
Flanja.
A lot going on. Have you guys seen this movie? Okay. So the one I wanted to see was Moon. Let me see if this works. The saltiest dogs have resubscribed Prime for 8 months. Hey, that's pretty good, he says. Or they say. Thanks. Woo, woo, woo. All right. Would you rate Moon 44? Why are there so many stars, man? Don't prompt me to rate. Let's see this. Let's see if this shows up on stream.
The year 2038.
Hold on. let me put this in a proper window so we can all watch together. Is that okay, Sam?
Okay. Do I have to watch it on stream?
No. I'm going to make it in a proper window. Moon 44 trailer. All right. I'm going to play Moon 44 trailer, and then you can pick a Roland Emmerich trailer.
Okay.
I can't tell if this is a... Well, the full movie is on. So his newest movie is called Moonfall. Okay. I'm putting this in the thing.
The year 2038.
That's quiet.
A world of intergalactic corporations locked in ruthless rivalry.
Aliens.
A world of desperate technologies competing for shrinking resources.
I wonder if this is...
Holy shit, what are all prisoners?
You're an ex-quiet
pilot. You're some kind of...
Oh, it's a guy.
Shut up!
One man's courage triumphs over savagery and greed.
Our defense system is based on the perfect interaction of pilot and navigator.
I can't get it louder, I'm sorry.
It's the dude from Terminator that we were just talking about.
A world of struggle, of fear, and of hope.
You got it! Leave us alone!
This plan will never work!
It's Michael Paré.
Yeah, well, who's Michael Paré?
Streets of Fire?
Got these faggots we don't fuck.
Whoop!
And I ain't going back to prison.
Problematic.
The out is open. You need a friend.
Bandits approaching quickly.
Lisa Eichhorn. Malcolm McDowell. Michael Paré. An Roland Emmerich film, Moon 44.
I don't really understand what that was about.
I wonder if it has, if it's like, it looks like it's like really taken from, what's that book by Robert Heinlein, the moon one,
Stranger in a Strange Land.
Right.
Isn't that Heinlein?
Like moon.
Lavaca says it makes more sense if you've seen the previous 43 moons.
Well, the previous 43 are graphic novels. So the moon is a harsh mistress. I wonder if it has some influence from that, because that's like a book about like us populating the moon and there being these corporations that are at war with each other.
Well, the corporation thing sounded very like Weyland Yutani.
Yeah.
And like this whole helicopter thing wasn't in the trailer, was it?
No, yeah.
You need a friend.
They're flying shit around.
Some of these taglines are hilarious for these movies. We need a tagline. How about in the outer zone, need a friend?
I thought that looked spiffy though.
Yeah, I'd watch it. But you know, I'm a sucker for this kind of sci-fi shit. Also, Michael Paré on this version of the poster, he's got like the whole top billing. And this is like an early Roland Emmerich movie, right? But like, I love how in the trailer it's like a Roland Emmerich film.
Yeah.
Did Sam really attend Sandwich High School? Cinematic asks.
Yeah. So did Nate. We were both graduates of Sandwich High School.
I don't remember.
Instead of classes, instead of classes, they made us eat sandwiches.
Yeah, it was dope. And
all right, you ready?
We do make dope sandwiches now.
There are good sandwiches.
Oh, for Christmas, you're coming home, right?
Yeah.
Mom is very excited, and you are going to be, I'm requesting now an impartial judge for our sandwich contest, because my sandwiches are dope and she thinks she makes better sandwiches. So we'll have a sandwich contest and sandwich.
Okay. All right. You guys ready?
Head up. Whoa, he doesn't even wait to the end. He's hitting it in the beginning. He wants everyone to know what they're in for. Okay.
I like the song.
Peaceful scientific discoveries were turned into dangerous weapons by the USA. I always believed in the positive aspect.
It's very John Carpenter-y.
Yeah.
It's like a music video. Invasion! Invasion!
3 minutes, 40 seconds. Target control. Switch to the automatic control. What's wrong? Initial radiation. Maximatic. Order. Area to be radiated is on the screen. It's in the Indian Ocean. The same coordinates as the. We don't have enough time. They've started the countdown already.
You must stop the countdown! Billy, try to stop it! He's not gonna make it!
Yeah, it's. I can't get it higher. Sorry. Or maybe I can.
It's so weird. Was there not enough movie to make a trailer out of?
Dico Nemo says very Videodrome-esque. And that's what I was thinking. It's like, in the last ones, he's like ripping off movies. What year was this, Sam?
84. This was before the last one.
But what year did Videodrome come out?
I think it was in 1999. 83.
So, it's kind of close. But yeah, it feels like he was very influenced and he was like, I'm going to make my trailer like Videodrome trailer. Is it propaganda? Yeah, it's future propaganda.
Oh, did you hear Anne Rice is dead? Or maybe she's undead.
Oh! Good one. Okay. So he did Stargate, Independence Day, Universal Soldier, The Day After Tomorrow, 10,000 BC. Never heard of that. You heard of 10,000 BC?
I saw 10,000 BC in theaters.
Well, is there dialogue in it?
I forget.
Oh, Sam.
What?
Guess what movie he did?
What?
Oh, wait, no, this is another twin movie. I saw White House Down and I thought of Patriot Has Fallen.
Oh.
Olympus Has Fallen, but White House Down is Magic Mike.
I was looking at the writing credits.
He doesn't do a lot of his own stuff. It seems like he steals a lot of shit. So, like, if 10,000 BC is the Mayan one, there was a dope Mayan movie, right? That wasn't called 10,000 BC. What was that one called? Apocalypto?
Yeah, that was that guy.
Amazing.
That was directed by that guy whose politics you really like.
Orson Scott Card?
No, the...
The Mel Gibson movie? Yeah.
Oh, Mel Gibson, yeah. You're always talking about how you politically align with him.
He's charismatic, you know? I don't really know much about what he says, but he says it with such conviction that, you know, you gotta... Okay, hold on. I'm going to show you guys a poster, and I want to know if you think this is worth watching for our Roland Emmerich retrospective. You guys ready? Boom. Look at what's going on in this. Is this the ghost from the other movie? Or the puppet from the other movie? What is this?
Whoa.
On a crazy night in Hollywood, anything can happen. Obviously, this movie's called Ghost Chase. All right, you guys ready for Ghost Chase? All right, oh now, bing bong bong. Let me see. Sorry. Okay. 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 What are we doing? What are we even doing at this point?
This would be a really great movie.
She lit a cigarette, both hands behind her back. Thought she
meet Fred,
like a choice of
Laurie, and Warren.
I will now proceed with the reading of the will.
What is Warren from? Was he one? Is this guy from one of the National Lampoon Vacation movies?
And Warren.
Does he play Rusty in one of these movies?
I will now proceed with the reading of the will.
They're about to inherit their first big break in Hollywood. But someone is interested in their friend from the past, who holds the key to their fortune.
Off of my new movie monster.
What? A friend
it's
who is about to take
European
them,
vacation.
If their spirits are willing, on a wild ghost chase.
Before she
they're gonna have the time of their lives.
It's like E.T. if E.T. had hair and was a butler. Nine makes them pretty quiet all night, and they say, I don't like this. That's pretty funny. That's pretty funny. Oh, man. Oh, man. Yeah, I don't... What the fuck? And, like, I don't know. That was so weird. And that... sorry. I'm, like, confused.
Yeah.
I'm like,
That was a bummer.
That was
guys,
a bummer.
Guys, I'm sorry about the show. I'm sorry about this show.
You know what, though? I personally, I don't know what chat feels like. I know we're not getting through, like, crazy trailers submitted. You know, we're running out of time very shortly. But I do like the rabbit holing, so I do like how we did this. But it's funny because it's like, Roland Emmerich is, like, a well-known director. But when you look at, like, all his movies like this, it's like, all right, we looked at, like, a bunch of shitty movies. So, let's, you know, Universal Soldier, was that a good movie?
Let's watch the trailer for... Let's end it with a trailer for Universal Soldier. I think Universal Soldier was popular.
But just let's go through. So, like, Universal Soldier, all right. So, Benefit of the Doubt, we'll say it was good. Stargate, I think, was good. Independence Day, obviously huge. This was the Godzilla that was huge. Horrible. But bad, right? Yeah, yeah. So, like, was this should huge? Be, like, an X. Yeah, there was, like, Godzilla on cups. Like, I mean, as a marketing
thing. Yeah. They marketed. I think it probably flopped, though.
So Universal Soldier gets some Stargate to Independence Day, then Godzilla, which sucked, and then Patriot, I don't remember. And then you start hitting all these things. But Anonymous.
Independence Day was good enough to, like... for like a lifetime of movies, you know, like Godzilla sucked. Patriot was good enough. I bet that made money. Day After Tomorrow, I bet made money. 10,000 BC.
Day After Tomorrow was huge.
Bet made money. 2012.
Do you remember 2012?
Yeah.
So
John Cusack.
You have a funny story about, or you or Zach has a funny story about this.
Zach has a funny story that he heard secondhand that, like, John Cusack's manager went to go talk to him on 2012, and there were, like, crab people, like, people in, like, crab men costumes outside John Cusack's trailer. And so the manager, like, sees it. It's like, that's weird. And, like, walks in the trailer and goes, oh, what's the deal with the crab people? And John Cusack just looks at him and goes, I don't know. I don't know.
I don't know what movie this is I'm doing. What are we doing here?
Yeah, like,
I love that.
How would I know? How would anyone know what's going on in this shit show?
Good paycheck for John Cusack.
See, Anonymous was a Shakespeare movie, a high exciting drama movie about the playwright, the bard himself, William Shakespeare. Ooh, this disaster movie sounds fun. Stonewall. What's that about? Like a giant stone wall that, like, destroys the earth? Probably, right?
I think it's about a cafe.
No, I think it's about a giant stone wall that destroys the earth. A young man's political awakening in the coming age of days and weeks leading up to the Stonewall riots. Okay, what are these Stonewall riots?
Is Roland Emmerich gay? Can I ask that, or is that not a good question to ask?
I don't know. He's German, if that helps.
Oh, Jonathan Rhys Meyers looks different. Why would it be a bad question to ask? I don't know. I don't want to ask people's... Then the only reason I ask is because, you know, Stonewall was, you know, a big historical moment. And I feel like a lot of people, you know, who direct movies have, you know, passion behind it. Like, I really want to get the story out there. And maybe that would be like, oh, that's why, you know, he wanted to get the story out there. You know, like, he's way into Stargates, and he has to do a lot of Stargates. I don't know. Anyway, I think we have time for two more trailers each, Sam. What do you think?
Okay, yeah, that sounds good.
Okay, turn that off, hit this thing. Let me see where I'm at. What did you have? I had... okay, I got one. I think I'm next. And again, like... Copy, like, address. I feel... We got so many good submissions. We got a ton of them. And we did get doubles. And I apologize for people that see something and they're like, I submitted that. Why did that person get credit? We're just going in submission order. So, like, if you submitted something, and unfortunately, we don't have it set up where it tells you if you submitted a double or not. Yeah. Okay. And one of these days, when Sam has more time... Or we're linking up. We'll do, like, supplemental streams, and we'll just get the best of the rest or something, you know, and watch shit we missed, maybe? What do you think, Sam?
Yeah.
Is that too extra? I'm going to be an extra? Okay. Hitting the button now.
Problematic.
It wasn't problematic. That's something.
And the armies gathered for the Battle of Armageddon to the place in the Hebrew tongue called Megiddo.
For 2,000 years, we have waited. For 2,000 years, we have known. For 2,000 years, the world has feared that one day would be the last day. Now, in 2001, that day may be tomorrow.
You will be punished!
Is that, what's his name? Charlton Heston?
No, I think that's, Michael York.
Is this a religious movie? Is this a sad movie?
I mean, it's got that cool-ass devil.
Megiddo.
You don't have a chance in hell of getting what you want.
Oh,
I'll always
yes.
have a chance in hell, David.
Michael Biehn.
Is Michael Biehn... Okay, hear me out, hear me out.
Wait, I just want to go back, just to take note of this. If you go back just a little, to like 33.
For 2,000 years, the world has feared.
No, go to like 130.
Chance in hell of getting what you want.
This movie about the end of the world. All right, play.
Oh, I'll always have a chance in hell, David.
Was scheduled for release. Keep playing. 10 days after 9/11.
Wow.
I mean, I bet that's why we don't know about this movie.
I think there's a few more reasons why we don't know about this movie.
it's a movie about the world ending, and it came out 10 days after the world was felt like it was ending for a lot of people, you know.
The funny thing, I don't know, I didn't really get a lot of, like, ooh. It's a lot of like montage of shit going on, right? Like blah blah blah.
The devil was really cool.
The devil was really cool. Is this saying the devil came from space, or he shot like light out of his hand, and then he destroyed Italy? It's like the building's already fucked up, you know. Like,
yeah. Why? Why? He's
Egypt.
must have shit aim. Like, why aren't you aiming for the fucking the Vatican, right? You know, like, you're right there.
See all the planes coming out? Look at the planes! Yeah. This is bad effects for even back then.
Yeah. And that font is pretty gross.
I'm going to let me ask you if you agree. You're off camera. You've tilted out. Let me ask you this. Michael Bean has been in enough movies. Well, they get 75%. That's 3 points. He's been in enough movies here where I feel that, like, we should give bonus points to Secret Beans. Because I think we, you know, season one, our secret, like, buzzword actor? Or, I don't know. What was the Pee Wee's Playhouse thing? The secret word? Anyway, Jack Black, season one, got bonus points because he was in the background of a lot of stuff. This year, season two, secret actor... Or surprise actor, I'd say Michael Bean. What do you think? He's been in enough movies. No, we're Prima 8. All right, so who's that?
I like it.
All right, so that got 3 points from chat. I'm going to give it a point because it's hot garbage and it's on target. But it wasn't like, oh my God. I didn't oh my God that. But
I'm giving it a point also.
Okay, so what was that one called?
Sorry, guys. Mageddon or something like that?
Magedia. Oh, Flange submitted that. Flange is getting the finger to the pulse of chat. Got 3 points from chat. Bonus point for Michael Bean, 4 points. 1 point for me, that's 5 points. And then Sam gives it...
a point.
That's 6 points for Flange. Wow, with authority. All right, Sam, you are up next. Wait, I want to say, holy shit. Hold on.
What?
Hold on. What? We have an update on Timmy's Secret Santa, okay? If you're just joining, I'm raising Secret Santa money. You can see a Nightbot. Dollicker just kicked off the Nightbot there. We're trying to upgrade Timmy's stream gear, and we want the donation to be separate than the movie fundraising, which this channel is always doing to get the money together for the Mars movie, which is in production. All the stuff these guys have done is done. Trevor's parts are done. The movie has been edited to where they want it to be, and so they're just animating it now. So that's coming out, but they still need money for the production. All the money donated to this channel will be going towards that movie. Side note, we've been trying to get Timmy's Zucchini Boys and his game streams back up and running, and people are loving those, but we're having some technical difficulties with his equipment, so we've been raising money to get him some stuff for Christmas. Just now, Ari Sensen tipped $100 towards that. Dollicker GFY has tipped a few times with crazy different increments, but we appreciate that as well. Leet and 420, and I think there's a 69 in there. Rongina just threw down 200. Guys, we're getting Timmy a dope computer, so what? He can stream. Right. Oh, you don't want, you, should I return it?
What? No, that's wild. But I think it's really, I think Ari Sensen is really funny. Do you mean Arisen Sun?
Is that what it is?
I think so.
It could be a risen sun. It could be a risen sun. I've said it twice and no one corrected me though, so Ari Sen Sun could be it. And
Arisen Sun also 2 hours ago, I didn't look at it, I feel bad, donated $100 for the Mars film. Thank you very much.
Holy shit.
This is for the fund. I don't need to say anything else. Love you guys. Love you.
Are you sure it's a risen sun? Because Ari Sen's son could be cool too.
I mean, doesn't a risen sun make sense? Sun's rise?
I don't know. Ari Sen's son I like. Anyway, sorry. Here's the thing is I can read, but when you put it all together, you don't know where it breaks up. Like, do you know Rongina? That's not what his name was. We've just been calling him that, and he changed it. It was Rongina. Isn't that crazy?
Everyone just calls
him Rongina now. Yeah, it was Rongina.
It was Rongina?
Or Rongina.
No, it was Rongina.
Rongina. All right. Anyway, it's going to stick. Professor Marth live? Guess what?
Yeah.
He's not even a professor. He's a TA.
Professor Marth, wait, I forget. Maybe this is like where this joke came from. And maybe this is something that we talked about on stream over a year ago. And I'm just repeating myself at this point. But when the joke we had, whenever the live episode of Whitest Kids starts out with the title, Whitest Kids You Know, Live in New York. And every time we would like that would happen, I just remember Trevor all the time would be like, the whitest kids you know live in New York.
Fact.
Yes. Fact. They live in New York.
I just want to say Dalek or GFY also tipped 1337. Merry Christmas, Timmy. Doritos chip. Directionality tipped 420. Gene Thu tipped 1337 as well. Is 1330, is that like Leet? That's me, that's that right? Leet?
Wait, 1337?
Carl Box says, you can refer to me as Carl LB Ox. Got it, done.
Car Pound Ox.
How do you request a trailer to watch? Is it in the donation form? No, the trailer submissions are here up in Misery Loves Us, and you just submit, and then we vibe it, and then we miss half of them, and everyone gets pissed anyway, so I apologize. I feel, though, here's the thing, and I don't know if Sam does this, but I think we've talked about this, and you do. Well, we're selecting trailers. I'm not even looking at who's selecting the trailers. I'm just looking at, like, the title and the context, you know, and I'm just like, you go off that vibe. So some people are like, you never watch my trailers. You never watch my trailers. You always watch the same people. And it's like, the funny thing is, and we have watched a lot of the people that are already on the board, but it's not that I know it's them. It's, I think they're just very good at writing context. So what was the last one we wrote? All right. So the last one, Megadidio, was from Flanger, who's on the board. And it just says Judgment Day. Michael Biehn, check. Exploding Landmarks, you betcha. Satan, I wouldn't let Sam down. Runtime 144. And that's a great context description because I know how long the trailer is and it has all these points that I like. And that got me. So we're in. Sam, you got something up for us next?
Yeah.
Foxy Driftwood tipped $10.
Western 1, tracks are clear all the way to L.A.
Okay, Western 1.
There's something wrong with the controls here. What track are we on?
You're headed for Union Station, and you're going way too fast.
Jesus.
In the news, authorities are still investigating the train accident, and it may have been due to unusually strong solar winds.
Brian Lee is a 15-year-old genius.
We were subjected to a solar
flare. Voiceover voice.
Massive power surges, blackouts, and sure, global chaos. We can't predict these flares. Maybe someday.
But not by tomorrow.
Who can predict solar flares?
These calculations are all in longhand.
Like you said, there's no technology to do this, so I just had to do it myself.
But his special gift...
When did you say this was going to happen?
...is also...
In less than 18 hours.
...a dangerous curse.
We need to alert people to take cover.
So if you'll excuse me, I have a child prodigy to find.
He sounds like the kind of man I'd like on my team.
Now,
He's in danger. We have to find a way to alert people.
With the help of his professor.
I am not going to let you get away with this.
He must warn the world.
Now let's kick some ass.
Before it's too late.
What the hell was that?
That's an airplane, I think. Probably the first of many.
Regent Entertainment presents.
Don't look at the airplane, I think. Movie. Probably the first.
The person who can get us to in under an hour.
Of the year. Tracy Gold.
The job opening for a bouncer down at the club I worked at. The scientist gig doesn't work out.
Solar Destruction.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
I love how hard it is. Hold on. The jumping off the wall to punch somebody. What was the first movie to do that? It was funny when everyone else started doing that.
The job opening for a bouncer.
Oh, wait, let's play that first voiceover line. Like the voiceover guy fumbles it. Like,
One take, baby.
Yeah.
One take.
They're like, this is the best we got. It's the voiceover guy. Wait, play
Western
it.
Western 1, yeah. Tracks are clear all the way to L.A. Western 1.
There's something wrong with the controls here. What track are we on?
You're headed for Union Station, and you're going way too fast.
Jesus.
Sorry, we're going to watch a whole intro.
It may have been due to unusually strong solar wind.
Brian Lee is a 15-year-old genius.
If we were subjected to a solar flare, what would the damage be?
Massive power surge.
Train accident. It may have been due to unusually strong solar wind.
He's like, weird. I just wrote a report from my high school science class about solar activity. I wonder if this makes me important.
Brian Lee is a 15-year-old genius.
If we were subjected to a solar flare, what would the damage be?
Also,
power surges.
I love that it's like there's the whole thing where she's like, all these calculations are done out in longhand. And he's like, yes, you said there was not a computer that could do this kind of processing. So I did it all out myself. It's like, yeah, you can use a calculator for the addition and stuff, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. Calculators do this too.
Blackouts, sure, global chaos.
We can predict these flares. Maybe someday.
But not by tomorrow.
Who can predict solar flares?
These calculations are all in law.
You
said there's no technology to do this, so I just had to do it myself.
But his special gift.
When did you say this was going to happen?
Is also.
In less than 18 hours.
A dangerous curse.
We need to alert.
A dangerous curse. So smart.
People to take cover.
So if you'll excuse me, I have a child prodigy to find.
He sounds like the kind of man I'd like on my team.
What?
No.
He's in danger. Like, we have
why
to find
throw that
to
line
alert.
In there? And also, why, like, do you want to throw it in so much that you're like, all right, well, we don't really have a close-up of him saying that. We have it in there. It's just like, it's so weird that we're hearing... He's just the kind of man I want on my team. And you're like on this other character for that. I don't know.
Yeah. Solar Flares, Regent Entertainment. This will be a production company to watch, guys.
Yeah.
Is this the new Full Moon?
Western 1 tracks are clear all the way to LA.
I just think the beginning was funny where it's like, oh, we're watching a train movie.
Also, I love this. You're going to Union Station and you're going way too fast.
Way too fast, man. Ease it up a bit.
There's no like urgency in this guy's voice. Wait, play it.
Western 1.
There's something wrong with the controls here. What track are we on?
You're headed for Union Station and you're going way too fast.
Shouldn't the guy know what track he's on?
Way
though?
Too fast.
What track are we on? What does a train do? You didn't say anything about brakes.
What track are we on?
You're headed for Union Station and you're going way too fast.
Jesus.
Bestiality is way against park regulation.
Somebody's got to move their truck. That's my favorite
First
line
of all,
from that.
You got to move.
Have you ever told anybody in the commentary about that?
I think so. I think, yeah, that first of all, someone's going to have to move their truck. We were shooting the slapping sketch in Central Park and a cop came by, or not even a cop. It was, it was like a park ranger. He opened with, first of all, somebody's going to have to move their truck. And so we.
Same as the Wolf Theater still open?
No. I think you mean the Pack Theater. I think you mean the Pack.
Pack Theater. All right. I'm going to give that, I don't know. Here's the thing. I was like, that's an easy 1 point for me, but it could be 2 points because of like, you know, I'm going to give it 2 points. Hot to God or Bench.
I'm giving it 2 points, definitely. That was, okay. I think, the funnest trailer to watch tonight so far. It's so bad.
Yeah, yeah. Hot garbage. All right, so that's four from the Brown Boys. I'm not breaking the medallion for that or reuniting the medallion. You think it's more, you think Double Dragon, you think they put the medallion together or they break it to, like, release the energy? Wow, chat gave that 3 points. 7 point trailer. Who submitted Solar Flare, Sam?
Wait, what? Oh, Solar Flare was. But wait, the at the end of the trailer they call it something different. Solar Destruction. I don't know which name we want to go with. Doesn't work
out. Solar Destruction.
That was Lobaka, 1977.
Good one, Lobaka. But even listen to the voiceover on this part. Ready?
Scientist gig doesn't work out.
Solar Destruction.
Solar Destruction. Man. So that's...
You often don't get a bad voiceover guy like that. I think that's pretty great.
Or, alternatively, like, somebody listens to it before it goes out onto the trailer, and they're like... Okay.
Yeah.
All right. This is my last trailer of the night. Hold on. Sorry, guys. Why do birds? Oh, nope. There we go. All right.
In 1908, it flattened hundreds of square miles. It's been blamed for the extinction.
This one was submitted a lot.
Scientists are wondering, could it happen again?
Mr. President, got some.
Is that Michael Bean too?
Like a vast minefield.
I think it might be.
Traveling 34,000 miles an hour on a collision course with Earth.
If we don't break it up or stop it, millions of people will die.
Asteroids so big. So powerful, so close.
My fellow Americans,
the National Observatory discovered that a number of asteroids now pose a significant risk to our planet.
I don't know. Honey, I'm really scared.
But how can the entire world prepare for the ultimate disaster?
Police, fire, medical agencies have now been
put in point to whoever submitted this.
Civilians out of here!
A world hoping for a miracle.
These things can come right down on your head, and there's not a thing you can do about it.
The human race would be lucky to survive.
Now, without weapons powerful enough to destroy them all.
We've got thousands of pieces coming at us.
And with families torn apart.
Ben!
You all just stay in the basement!
My father and my son are out there.
Mom! The only thing they have to hold on to is each other.
Is each other?
The inevitable is here.
Dallas.
You never see Dallas get blown up.
Falling.
No, my God, no!
No, my God, no.
Predator, and Daylight. Starring Michael Biehn.
Welcome to your worst night.
Michael Biehn.
And Annabella Sciorra.
We gotta do something!
NBC's highest rated blockbuster miniseries since 1988 that captured over 75 million viewers.
Hang on!
Where an earth-shattering disaster can tear the world apart. but not the will to survive. When courage is tested.
Slipping!
Grab my hand.
And heroes are born. The end of the world is just the beginning.
Zombie Bender says, oh, it's based on
Who
Chicken
will
Little.
Survive. Asteroid.
Oh my god. I
was
love that.
Was that a made for TV movie?
It sounded like it was based on the miniseries.
Oh, it was based 30. On a miniseries.
That sounded like it. I don't know. I could be wrong. But, like in the very beginning, are these quotes like, you know, like, look at the quotes.
In 1908, it flattened hundreds of square miles.
It's are these been like real?
For the extinction of the dinosaur.
America Online.
Scientists are wondering.
Scientists ponder the possibility. Astronomer, Sheffield University, uncredited, unnamed astronomer. And then you don't know the context. ... Impact will occur. Like, happen come again. On. I don't know. I'm, is it Michael Biehn? Have I been saying it wrong the whole time?
I think you could say it however the fuck you want.
In 1908.
That is funny. Okay. It is based on the video game for Atari 2600. Hilarious.
I mean,
Biehn.
I was thinking of that when there was the laser
on the front of the jet.
On the front of the jet, that was pretty great.
Yeah. Okay.
Ending strong.
It was the funny thing is it felt like a long trailer and it was only 2 minutes and 30 seconds. So it's like, that's pretty funny to me. You know when like a regular trailer just feels like a slog. It's fun for me. all right, Asteroid from 1997. I give that 2 points. That's like exactly what I wanted for this theme for this episode. So it's like perfect in there. And then the Michael Biehn Bine, that's an additional point. So that's so far 3 points. And that lady, I think, was from Sopranos.
Annabella Sciorra.
She was the Gumar. Guma?
Yeah.
Any sexy AIDS and diarrhea stories?
Aren't all the AIDS stories sexy and diarrhea stories sexy? Depends on what you're into.
What do you think there, Sam, for a point?
Aren't all Lubega stories sexy? 2 points.
Oh, it's 5 for the Brown Brothers.
That's an easy 2 for me.
Let me see. That was submitted a bunch. Let me just make sure I get the first person. There's so many good movies in here. Ooh,
two points from chat.
2 points from chat. 4 points from us. 1 point bonus. 7 points? Yeah. That makes sense, right? Hmm. Did I do that right? Yeah, 7 points.
Yeah,
7 points. I will say, a lot of people submitted Titan A, and I fucking love that movie. But I feel that's very post-world ending, right? They're like looking for like the After Earth kind of thing. I do love that movie, though, Titan A. Okay, that was called Asteroid, and that was submitted by Niamix, first on the board with that one. Congratulations.
Okay.
Congratulations. All right, Sam, you got one for Suspicious Blacklight Stain. Going to bed. Have a good night.
All right. Before I start the last trailer of the night, I just want to say we like to have fun, but also. They're just want to say if like for anyone who's been affected by the recent tragedies in Illinois and Kentucky with the
it's like 7 tornado. States, right?
Yeah, it's so crazy.
That's
so
awful. Crazy. Yeah.
All right. Okay, trailer.
Sorry, I paused it. I just want to seem like callous about being like, it's a, but no, that's awful shit. It is fucking devastating. It's awful. I watch the news all day today about that. It is crazy stuff. Reach out to your friends, hug them. And what's nuts is I remember watching the news and here they were like showing it and they were like, something bad is about to happen out here, like in the next day or so. And so it's like, it was so crazy, like happening. And weather right now, and it, you know, it's an appropriate topic with like weather change and stuff for the theme tonight, because, you know, with climate change and stuff, even here where I live in Massachusetts, we had a crazy tornado warning where like at 1 a.m, you know, everything was going off. We had to like get into our basement and it was like coming right through our, and we're like, what the hell is going on? So, crazy stuff. So reach out to your friends in the affected areas, give them a hand. I have you know, friends that were affected by, you know, floods and disasters in New Orleans, and it's always good to offer them a place, an alternative, so they're not like, I have to stay here forever and deal with this, you know. Give them an out, help your friends out. It's that time of year. Be friends to your neighbors. All right, and with that, Sam's last trailer of the night. Or unless, I shouldn't say with that. If you have more to say about that, it's your show.
No. Yeah, let's just, yeah, last trailer.
Control, we have confirmed cloud
formation. Oh, Schlitty Twitch. Yeah, I'm sorry. I ruined your bit.
Those aren't normal.
Yes, sir. This is Frank. Project Rain Dance is a success.
Why is it freezing?
I don't know.
We've got another cell, a bad one.
Where?
Here.
WeatherSat Delta picked up a blip on the radar.
Did anyone hear me?
Mind telling me what a blip is? The temp just crashed in the test area.
Guys.
We got a twister!
Like they didn't notice? Aren't they there for twisters?
The government's been trying to control the weather for years.
No, this doesn't look like control. Mayday. This looks more like out of control.
We could have stopped something that's gaining the momentum to kill thousands, maybe millions of people.
Lord, help us.
There's nothing we can do.
See, I was just trying to do like a light, quick, like, hey, there's serious stuff going on, and let's throw it to this insensitive trailer. But then Nate had to ruin it by really like going out there and getting really sincere about everything.
Sincerity is the death of comedy.
You really is the death dug of into that one.
All right. Let's pick another one. I want you to get a do-over. I want you to do a do-over.
So that's Nate's fault. I know. I wasn't being insensitive. Nate was being insensitive.
Wild Man shared 3 bits. Thank you very much. I watched Wild Man play Battlefield this week.
I'll pick one more.
Should we vote on that one, though?
Yeah, let's vote on that one.
Ice Twister. I think that was shit, and I'm not going to give it a point. I shouldn't say that. I feel I affect the points.
I'm gonna give it a point. I think it was crazy shit.
Rongina gifted a tier one sub to Wild Man. Wild Man been playing some Magic the Gathering, I think I saw. I didn't watch that, but I have been. I'll give props to people playing Battlefield because no one's playing it. Yeah. All right. So. Sam gives it a point. It didn't have Michael Biehn in it, right? As far as I know, it did not have Michael Biehn in it. I just, as a trailer, you know, obviously I ruined the bit, and I got that, like, as soon as somebody, I didn't even get it. Somebody in chat said it, and I was like, fuck. I fucked it up. But as a trailer, it was pretty boring. But I do like the part where they're like, hey guys, there's a tornado. While they're all like waiting for a tornado to come, like, oh, there it is, the column thing. I thought it was more of like a breeze. That's looking like we can move on. That's looking like a 0.76% no. So that's 0 points, and I'm gonna give it zero points.
You gave it 1 point. I'm gonna give it 1 point. I feel like it got a bad rap.
I'll give it 1 point because I feel guilty for ruining the bit.
All right. Now can I not?
Who gets the points, though? Who gets the points?
Speedpunk 1996.
Sorry.
Now, to make sure we don't end on a sour note, Nate, you ready? Are we ready?
Yeah, I'm trying not to step on your shit.
Oh, if I say, are we ready? You just say, yeah, we're ready.
Yeah, we're ready.
Nate, that's so fucked up.
It's on me. It's on me.
That's on you. You're being very insensitive. All right. hold on. I actually have another. A real. Oh, shit. Wait. The one I had, it just went away.
What about video game trailers? I'm trying to, you know what? trailers for video games don't get me.
Or video game movies.
Are there a lot of video game movies? How about we do?
Yeah.
How about
they're really bad? Theme
where it's movies based on an established intellectual property.
Okay. Well, that can be. I think we should vote. We haven't voted in a while. Legend. You ready?
Yes.
Something unimaginable. Something unexplainable.
This thing we know about.
We can only conclude that it's foreign in nature.
We're talking about deploying armed forces in a major city. I need to know exactly what the hell we're up against.
Something extraordinary.
You said it was big. You didn't say it was something that could swallow a bus.
We'll turn our world into a battlefield.
Is this a Jar Jar movie?
Yeah.
It feels like Gungans. Are these Gungans?
Yeah, when the Gungans strike.
Dragon Wars.
D-War.
D-War.
Hashtag D-War. What the fuck was that?
I liked it. I'd give that a point.
It began as a legend.
It looks like Phantom Menace, right?
Yeah, it? Totally.
So are those dragon people?
Something unimaginable.
Yeah, they're...
Something unexplainable.
I think they're ancient Chinese dragon people.
Whoa.
We can only conclude that it's foreign in nature.
Like, I think they fought forces in a major Chinese city. People.
I need to know exactly what the hell we're up against.
Mayor of Bagtown 69 says, I remember being hyped for this as a kid. Mayor of Bagtown says, I remember hyped for this. I don't remember being hyped for this. I don't remember this movie being a thing.
It's funny.
Wow, man, the theme is here. It's where the world blows up. Or is it established they're evil? Maybe they were here first.
Yeah, true.
Maybe the dragons did nothing wrong.
Maybe they have a movie called...
Dragon Wars.
Human Wars. Or H-Wars.
I love how the subtitle, see this? It's Dragon Wars, D-War.
Yeah, why isn't it D-Wars? Not to
be confused with Dragon Wars. Like, the it was just Dragon... This is the sequel to Dragon Wars. Yikes! Alright, so... I should wait. Should I wait to? Should we wait to vote until after, or no? Do you think it? Do you think our votes
wait like a second?
Dragon Wars D War. Okay. While people are voting on Dragon War D Wars, Dragon Wars C Words. All right. I'll give it a point. I'm being really loose with the points. This was, I guess this was the category I liked. What do you think about for themes?
Themes? I'll give one it, you one. Themes?
Or tell me what you would give it as a point.
I'd give it a point.
That's two for us. Were there any themes you wanted from last season that we didn't get to?
Movies about cars.
Okay. Do you just want to do a car movie or do you want to vote for one?
What?
Do you want to do a car theme one or you want to just vote on it? All right, that got 66. That's 2 points. That is four points for D-Wars. So you can put that in there.
We haven't voted in a while.
Okay. Before we do trailer of the week, let's do next week's theme. All right, so I'll let you choose. You want fast cars?
Fast cars.
I'll just do car movies.
Yeah, car movies. Automobiles. Where,
so car movies would be like the car would be like the main, like, so would Road Warrior Mad Max be a car movie or no? Because
yeah,
okay. And like
they're car centric. That those movies are very car centric.
Okay.
You know, like Cannonball Run, Smokey and the Bandit, Rush Junkies.
The Wraith? Or is it The Wrath? The Wrath
the Wraith? Wraith? Yeah, it's The Wraith.
All right. Interesting. All right. So next theme. What else? What do you want to do? I feel... So, before you mentioned movies about a place, but I feel that's kind of like I want to shape that up.
Like, movies like Shortcuts is about L.A. Nashville's about Nashville. Empire Records is about a record store called Empire Records. Or do you want to do workplace movies?
I want to say workplace. Like movies that take place, like the primary location is like work or the theme is the job. Like,
Working Girl.
What's that Michael Keaton one where he's like building cars? What was that one called?
I think that one's called Spotlight.
Okay, car movies, workplace movies. I can't see chat because I got the poll up. Anyone throwing anything out in chat? That's good.
Wait, hold on. I turned off the chat.
Your silence makes me think that no one in chat is throwing out good ideas.
Someone said Steven Seagal movies.
Too specific.
What about like action star movies? Is that too broad? Like, you know, like Seagal. Or what's that movie? That they're not great movies, but not the replacements, the replaceables, expendables, replaceables, movies with cast members of the Expendables.
Okay. I like that. We got two more.
What about... someone said period pieces. Yeah, if you want to
movies about go to menstruation. Sleep.
Yeah.
How about this? How about a category that's women assassin groups based off the original secret agent from the Revolutionary War? Too specific?
Too not specific enough. Spoof movies, I feel like we'll want to like kill ourselves by the end of it.
Yeah, they get bad real quick.
Oh wait, you were saying like product movies, weren't you? Or pre-existing IP? That's what you were
existing
saying.
IP. So it's like Star Wars wouldn't count because the movie spawned like the IP, but like, you know, games based on video game or movies based on video games. I wouldn't say movies based on like books necessarily, because it's like a lot of movies are based on books, but like say like the Twilight movies are, that's like, you know, a thing, you know? So I don't know. It gets kind of, wishy-washy, but you know, I don't want to say video games specifically, but like
non-movie based IPs. Punish Danis, I think, said it well.
Okay. Non-movie based intellectual property. And one more.
Or should you say non-movie or book-based IPs? Non-movie or literature-based IPs. So... Okay, so, but, I mean, that's like Battleship or Spider-Man.
Alright, one more. We have one more category.
I think comic books don't count as literature. The D&D movie.
Alright. One more theme.
Yeah, Punished Walrus. It's like a thing that we call Punished Walrus, Punished Ants.
I remember Punished Walrus had a different name, and I forget what the name was, but it was like, I remember when you change your name, and you're like, I've changed my name, I was this, and now I'm Punished Walrus, and I just read it in my head as Punished Anus right away, and that stuck. So, you get that middle school hazing right off the outset. Okay, we have space for one more theme. Does anyone in chat have a good idea for Sam?
Movies about things that come to life. Someone said toys that come to life, but I mean, you know, we could do like, you know, you think you got Mannequin, you got Indian in the Cupboard, Small Soldiers.
You just named like all of them. This seems like a very thin category. But hey, we're going with it. All right. You know what? I'm an idiot. While we were coming up with these, I should have put the poll up for the trailer of the week.
It's fine.
All right. So, while we're waiting for this, do you want to watch something? That's why we used to do it. See, I'm still getting my sea legs back. We used to do trailer of the week, and then while the poll was up, we would talk about themes. now we've talked about themes and have to wait until we make a new poll.
Alright, I got it. I got a trailer.
Before you play that, I went Christmas caroling with mom because her friends bailed and she like really wanted to go, and I was like, I do not want to go. But so I went anyway, and this girl, and I shouldn't have done this, I'm not making friends in this small town, but this girl was doing a solo or something, you know, and it was like the town's out, it's freezing cold, everyone's got like, candles and stuff. It's very like quaint. But I was like, sing about yogurt! Sing about yogurt! I didn't yell it out like I wanted to, because my mom would have killed me. But, you know, I wanted to be like,
so that's why you're not making friends?
Yeah.
Okay. You would have made friends if you yelled it out.
No. My instinct is to do something like that, which doesn't win me friends. I told you I put my OnlyFans link in a job application. But it was like I could have gone either way with it, you know? So it was like, they're like, this is interesting. And I'm like, yeah, I got to make that money. It shows I'm a go-getter. I'm an entrepreneur. Sell pictures of my feet for dudes to jerk off on. Two, not on. Anyway, hit play. Is this a Roland Emmerich movie?
Mm-hmm.
All units, this is 7 November golf.
He's too fast.
Panamanian government. Evidence of passengers dead or alive.
Please stand by.
My threshold for like Godzilla movies that I love is so low. And this was such a bummer.
Thing's only 200 miles off the eastern American seaboard. We don't even know what the hell it is.
It was so bad.
My thing with this was like somebody that like pitching this movie, like, let's make a Godzilla movie, like an American Godzilla movie. Let's make it lean and mean and like fast. And you're like, what? You just like just fucked up all this Godzilla shit, you know? Like this blue Godzilla, blue.
Yeah.
Like Godzilla is like very dinosaur-like. I remember when you finally see it, you're like, what the fuck is that?
Like half the movie is like them inside Madison Square Garden with tiny Godzillas.
Matthew Broderick's not even in the trailer. Yikes. God damn it, chat. Chat voted for things that come to life.
Oh, really? I hated that too.
We're never going to get car movies.
Wait, I never...
close.
I didn't vote. Fuck.
You didn't vote. It only lost by one vote. Or only one vote.
It lost by four.
I don't know. Things that come to life is going to be such a category, guys.
All right. Things that come to life.
You chose it.
I was doing a playoff of something.
Punish Wallers, this had a sequel? Godzilla had a sequel? Do you need to wait until the submission page is updated? No, you guys can vote now. You know, we understand when they come in, it comes in like a spreadsheet.
Okay.
Bitcoin says, yeah, don't listen to us. We don't know shit. It's like it's gonna be like everybody submitting like the same, like, I don't know. I'm you know what, here's the thing, is half these movies you watch I've never seen or heard of, and I'm surprised and delighted and I'm entertained, and I hope you are too. So I'm putting a lot of this on you guys. There's been a few episodes where like I had a bunch of movies in mind and then nobody submits them and I'm gonna play them anyway. This one I'm tapped out, it's all you. So yeah. All right, so let's do trailer of the week. I think right, we have here's the problem is I think we have too many high point value trailers.
I think there's seven. That's always a problem. We always kind of knock one off. I think I know which one we knock off. So here's the list: The Rapture, Miracle Mile, or I think there's six trailers. Miracle Mile, When the Wind Blows, Megiddo, Asteroid, and Solar Flare. So that's six, right?
What's after Megiddo? Asteroid and Solar Flare?
Asteroid and Solar Flare.
Yeah, we're one heavy.
I say let's let the wind blow when the wind blows off this list. Even though it was great, it's just like, I don't want to watch that next week. You know, like, these other ones are fun.
Yeah.
And I think it deserves 6 points. It just doesn't feel like trailer of the week material. So I would take that one off the list.
Okay. So The Rapture, Miracle Mile, Megiddo, Asteroid, and Solar Flare.
Yeah. It's a good list. You know what? I'm going to vote this time.
It's good. It's easier to vote when you see these like this, you know, like in a set. So everyone can see. My lighting is not as good as it was last week. Okay. This one's tough. The Rapture was a very cool trailer, and we opened with a good one, but, like, in comparison, it's not as silly, and, like, I know, I'm pretty sure I only gave Miracle Mile 1 point, but, like, in context, in comparison, when he's like, I'm the guy that picked up the phone, like, I think that's hilarious. Asteroid was fucking great. Solar Flare was good. This is a good grouping, let's say.
Yeah,
but it's a good list. It's not even like, oh, you voted. I got a vote of my... Oh, no. Oh, I'm panicking. Okay, trailer of the week. Are you going to say who you're voting for? Or are you going to be like, no, I don't tell people who I vote for?
I voted for The Rapture.
You're the one person that voted for The Rapture?
No, I didn't. That's kidding. I said that... As soon as I said that, one person voted for it. I said that when I had it. All right. I forget. The Rapture was that one really early that was, like, really good.
It wasn't as silly.
But it was cool, right? Yeah.
I voted for... I won't say who I voted for.
Ooh, it's a real barn burner, this one.
Yeah. Miracle Mile was the one where he was in the diner on the phone with the lady, or he gets a phone call, and then he's like, we gotta do stuff, and he's like running all over LA looking for, like, a helicopter pilot. Solar Flare was the kid in high school, right? Who, like, is like,
yeah, oh, the I boy know, genius. I can
predict solar flares, yeah.
It was the one where the bad voiceover guy. Yeah. Megiddo is the one with the with that demon. Yeah. That, like, alien devil thing. Asteroid. I'm surprised that Asteroid isn't doing as well as it is. That one was the one with Michael Biehn and the jets that shot lasers and all the fun stuff there. I didn't vote for Asteroid. I'm just surprised it's not doing better.
Oh, wow. You're telling people who you voted for? Okay, Bernie Sanders.
I'm telling people who I didn't vote for. I didn't vote for Asteroid, and I didn't vote for The Rapture.
And again, I'll say it one last time before we sign off. Secret Santa, if you do want to donate to help us raise money, or, I don't know, raise money, whatever.
The winner is Solar Flare.
Wow. Okay, so I voted for Miracle Mile.
I think we need to cap off the Secret Santa deal.
Why?
Because I think we have enough money to get Timmy some, like, really good equipment. I think we need to start putting some money of this into Mars now.
True. I'm not... All right. So here's the tough thing with computer parts is because of the shortage, even the used parts are very expensive. So
no, just getting, yeah.
like... Now I think we could actually just buy him new stuff. I will try and get the most bang for the buck. Yeah, Zucchini Boys needs higher production. Yeah. And a part of this is that Timmy's like, yeah, I just do the thing by himself. But we're like, yo, there's small things we can do to pump it up, you know. And a lot of you guys in chat have been really, really great helping out with, like, your areas of expertise with sound and stuff like that. So, and, you know, Timmy's, like, studio, let's say, is tough because he has his, like, living room and his kitchen. And a lot of stuff is in the kitchen. He can't, like, hook a computer up and all that stuff in the kitchen. So an overhead cam would be nice. We've talked about that, virtual cam. So, you know, a lot of this stuff will go into helping the production of Timmy because he's out.
Ilium works. And part of the impetus of this is someone, I don't even know who, but someone donated to him a very, like, decent graphics card. So he's got that, and that's part of the thing is he has this thing that is hard, that is harder to get, and would be a lot of the bad, a lot of the money would go into, like, finding him any graphics card. And so
the hardest thing to do we've done.
Yeah. And so now that it's like that far, we're just gonna, like, get him to have the computer that, like, at least, like, can use that graphics card properly.
Yeah. And so, yeah, I mean, we had the graphics card, and Sam and I did a video call. We were helping him hook it up, and it was like, you know, the one thing we were, like, texting on the side was like, this graphics card is way higher in caliber than the rest of the computer, and so that's gonna be the bottleneck. Like, it doesn't matter that he's got this, you know, dope graphics card. It's just that, like, you know, he's gonna have to deal with everything else. So now we do have some money.
Just to throw this out there, just so you get an idea what we're dealing with, is the motherboard he had, the manufacturer of the motherboard wasn't even on PC Parts Picker. So
it's an OEM board. It, like, didn't have a name. It, like, came with it. The computer was, like, an office computer that, like, still had the college that it was probably stolen from. So
it was a weird board.
There is a lot of odd stuff, but, you know, with this money that we're raising, we'll be able to get him something to build around it. Sam and the guys have put in money together to get him stuff. So we're just trying to make a nice, streamy Christmas. And again, all the money that goes to me for this, because, again, we don't want to confuse the accounts. So that's why the donation thing is under my name. And it can be on my stream. You'll see it, Nate Blackest. That will be all going towards his stuff. And again, you know, was it a lavalier? Could be in there if there's money for it. You know, like, I don't know if he has lights. Like, we have, Sam and I have been using these small lights that are, you know, there's nothing to them. But, oh, you can't see because it's lit up.
His modem's busted? I did not know that.
Hey, new modem. These things are great. Oh. That's the sound of the beep.
Buy Timmy a $10,000 setup, 4K ball cam for 4K balls.
Again, man. Like, we haven't raised crazy money for Timmy. We have, like, enough. Oh, fuck me. My fucking earbuds died. You know, we have enough to get him, like, something good used. More money helps. So I appreciate all the donations tonight. I'll see you guys next Sunday. Sam will be here for Christmas. We will do another in-person stream, and we'll have something. So we'll have to get a better theme for when we're hanging out together.
Let me see
who. Observertron 9000. Are you guys getting Timmy a great streaming setup so it's easier to buzz his balls on the stream? I think this was a good episode of Trailer Boys. What do you guys think? As I can't hear anybody.
Alright.
Hello?
I think this was fun.
Yeah, I always have a fun time doing this, so I appreciate people showing up to watch the show. Because if no one was here, then it wouldn't be as fun. But yeah, I appreciate it, guys. Always fun. See you next Sunday. I'll update the the website now, just to give you more details. Movies where things come alive, is that what we're saying? Or is there a better way to word that?
I like things come to life. I think that's good. Okay. And we're off.
All right. Did we raid? Should I stop streaming?
No, we didn't. I was just trying to get you.
Oh.
All right. Now we're raiding the older brother from Malcolm in the Middle. Yeah. And someone named Alana.
Okay.
See you guys.
Bye. Thanks. I love you guys.
And all right. Now we're raiding.